Broadcasting live to the UK. News, information, entertainment, and the best music from the past 40 years. This is Play2UK.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Isolde Hawkstan.
Sunday night. It's 7 o'clock, and the Human Zoo is now open. Call 01243 55 60 60. Skype play.radio.uk. Email studio@playradiouk.com. Conference on 0208 123 1088. And watch it all happen at stewandmatt.surfbeard.com. But be warned, this is a live community dedicated to discussing topics and taboos in a frank and open manner. So, if you're easily offended by an open-minded mass debate, then this show is not for you. And now, it's Not the Tommy Boyd Show with Matt and Stu, only on Play2UK.
Oh, sorry.
Well.
Huh.
Click that one, that's better. Good start to the show.
Great start to the show.
Thank you, Isolde. Very good.
Yeah.
More from Isolde coming up later on. It is just gone 7, Sunday night. Mm-hmm. It's the Not the Tommy Boyd Show, WTB.
That's right. Some weirdos.
I don't know. They just landed in the studio.
Walked in, Does your FM transmitter, when it switches to the night service, I'm an anorak. does it flip during the gap between? I'm a bad anorak, aren't I?
Ladies and gentlemen, Tommy Boyd, thank you very much for coming in.
Couldn't resist it.
How are you?
Never been better, actually. Yeah. Oh yeah. Today's the day, as I always say.
Seize it.
Yeah, been missing doing a bit of this.
Right.
A lot.
And we've missed you too, mate.
So. Are you kind?
You know. That.
Sometimes.
Not too much.
No. quite right. Occasionally pitch up and have a look at the stuff that's up there on YouTube, and it reminds me what fun you can have.
Yeah.
Mm. But I'm having a lot of fun at the moment with a new rate. Well, they're not that new, actually. Original has been working up and running for about a year, but they, for some reason, they got great music and they're great jocks, but nobody listened.
Right.
Because it's got a large catchment area, hasn't it?
1.6 million.
Yeah, yeah.
And then there's always the internet.
Yeah.
But they're not really, you know, going after that in a big way. Like a lot of radio stations, this place being an exception, they still don't quite know what to do.
Yeah.
With the internet, you see. I mean, you don't have issues with language and...
No.
Topics.
No.
But conventional radio does, because there's a controlling body that will jump on you, and doesn't James Whale know it?
Ofcom, yes.
Okay.
Everybody's best friend.
So we had long and heated discussions about, for example, whether I can say arse. Now, there are a couple of songs out there at the moment which have got arse in them. I think now, who is it? Oh, there's a couple of them that have got arse. Madonna's got an arse in one of her songs.
Yeah.
And,
oh, yeah, it's Justin, though, isn't it?
There's a lot of bloods and arses all over music.
Yeah, yeah. So if they can say arse in a song, you know, I say, can I call the newsreader a silly arse, you see? And we have these long and laborious, minute discussions with the general agreement that as long as I do it in a light-hearted way, I mean, management original don't care, because they're quite renegade, you know? But you've always got this fear of the police, as it were. So they sort of said, it's okay, you can call him an arse, but don't call him an arse. Mm. Call him an ass. You
right,
silly ass. You say it like that, and for some reason, it's acceptable.
Yeah, well, I had an issue. When I worked at Rugby FM, our programme control and breakfast presenter of the time, Dale Collins, we had a problem with the news computer bust, so we couldn't go into the news on the hour, and I said, well, bring the news, as soon as the computer's given itself a kick up the arse, press next. The next day, there was an email sent to every member of that company saying it will not be tolerated or accepted.
Jeez.
I know. What is wrong with that?
I'll tell you what it is we've talked about this on this show before. The man who invented the BBC was this enormous Scotsman. He was nearly 7 feet tall. I'm not joking. Thank you. Lord Reith. And Lord Reith, back in the early 30s, believed that the British public had to be protected from themselves because they were unwashed, ignorant and potentially very dangerous. So he created an organisation which was designed to make us all better people. And his ghost, quite frankly, still haunts the corridors, not only of the BBC, but of every broadcasting organisation in this country. The Americans are free from it.
Mm-hmm.
They do have their own controlling mechanisms, and the Aussies too. But they are less afraid than we are.
Yeah.
Because we are frightened people, the British, I think.
Well,
we're weak.
Prudish.
Frightened.
Prudish.
We're frightened, because we're descended from all the ones who didn't go to America in those ships.
Yep.
300 years ago, 200 years ago, neighbours of ours were going, I've had enough of this, I'm going to get onto a creaking boat, I might get eaten by sharks, and when I get to the other end, I'll probably get eaten by Indians, but I don't care, I'm fed up with this place, I'm going to start a new life.
They were the brave ones.
Yeah, and our ancestors, they stayed here and they went, oh, I'm not sure about this. So, we're descended from them, and however, some of us have a rogue gene, don't we?
Yeah.
Huh? Little fragment of some strange little chromosome that makes us want to say bollocks from time to time.
Occasionally.
With the microphone on.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what harm is there in that?
Absolutely none at all.
None whatsoever. It's only a word.
Yeah, it's good. It's great to have you, mate. It's good to see you again. I haven't seen Tom since December now, so,
Oh, Tom, don't put your beer on our charity card.
What have I done here?
Well, this
I thought it was a beer mat.
Well, no, this is a card we're going to auction off for charity.
Okay.
And we've been getting all the celebrities to sign it, so we've got Bobby Davro, Sean Williamson, Alex Lowe, many celebrities have signed it, and we're hoping that yourself will sign it for us tonight as well.
I certainly will.
If you can make it a little smaller than Bobby Davro, so that'd be nice.
Bobby Davro took up that much space.
Bobby Davro, where's the camera? Bobby Davro's... you see that? It's a megalomaniacal sort of effort there. Who's this? Who's more me? This little modest
that's John Archer.
John Archer.
John Archer, the comedian.
One top right, yeah.
Yeah,
okay.
And Tim Vine signed it as well, and hopefully when Chris Tarrant comes down in a few weeks, he'll sign it for us.
And Alex, is he coming down, Chris?
Chris Tarrant is coming down, yes.
He's a good lad, Chris Tarrant. Mm-hmm. Alex Lowe signed his, do you want me to sign it now?
Yeah, no, I'll just put
quick.
It's brilliant. While Tom's doing that, 01243 55 60 60. 01243 55 60 60 the number you can get through on.
Yep.
0208 123 1088. A bunch of stuff going on tonight. Mr. Boyd's in the studio, as we know. Isolde's joining us behind me, and the camera keeps flicking around to her, and she'll be doing some more music later on.
Yep.
Joe's here. Aaron's floating around in the background.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah, so
it's a busy day, and Tom's bought the wife.
I bought the blonde.
We couldn't fit her in the studio. So that's right.
She's lost she's dropped 7 pounds. She's
Stu's been doing the same. We've been doing the Play Radio Weight Loss Challenge.
How does that work?
Well, each week you take it upon yourselves to eat healthily and lose some weight, and then we measure up on the Sunday night show, and the final is next Sunday, and whoever wins £50 and a big hoodie sweatshirt with NTTBS on the front and PlayRadioUK.com on the back.
Are there no sexual incentives?
Unfortunately not, although...
I always think that would work so well. Looking. See, if you had the bonk diet, wouldn't it? We'd all be walking around, you know, like stick insects.
I haven't actually approached Joe.
If you knew you were
going to
get a really good night in the sack for dropping £2 in a fortnight, you'd do it. Easily, wouldn't you?
Well, I have to say, Stu looks really well for it, and he's been jogging and losing weight.
Did I say that to you when I came in?
Yes, you did, yeah.
I said that to you when I came in, when we were listening to the excellent music.
You did, thank you very much. Yeah, it's very nice of you. Let me just garner the female response to that idea then of maybe the winner of the right, that'll do nicely as Joe's finger is stuck right
there. Do you want to take one of them live? Let's have our first call.
This one. Hello.
Ah,
now how did I guess it was gonna be Alan?
Welcome
back,
Mr. Boyd.
Hello, Alan, how you doing?
I'm not bad. Evening, Joe.
Good evening.
All right, that'll do, Alan. That's quite enough, you sex pest. Thank you very much, Alan. Speak to you later. Bye-bye.
On the phone, hello?
Oh, I was hoping for Duncan Barkis.
You see, if both those guys were on the bonk diet, they'd be so thin we wouldn't be able to hear them.
Thank you. On the other line, hello?
Oh, you missed it, mate. You didn't press it.
Oh, there we go. It's not touch sensitive, is it? Hello on the phone.
Good evening. Is it me?
Is it you?
Good evening. This is the spirit of John Peel here. I just thought I'd phone up to ask the studio their opinion on some of the acts that are appearing at Glastonbury this year.
Well, Jay-Z, a bit worried about Jay-Z.
Why not, though? Why not, Jay-Z?
It's not really in the sense of Glastonbury,
it's not the sort of act that you'd expect at Glastonbury.
Well, come on, have we not got...
As I like to call it, I remember saying to Paul McCartney back in 1975 that Jay-Z wouldn't go down very well. It was a bit of advice that they ignored at the time, of course.
Are we not sick of the same three bloody headlines every year, which seems to be Paul McCartney, Paul Weller and Oasis? Isn't it about time we started getting some new acts into Glastonbury like Jay-Z?
Well, can I just say, I've got some cracking acts appearing at the John Peel stage this year. We've got the Band of Horses and Black Lips, I believe.
So all sounds very good, John.
Yeah, there's also another band here, which is quite rude. Am I allowed to swear? I remember my years at the BBC. I was not allowed to swear. In fact, I remember saying to Tony Blackburn one Christmas that if he slept with that prostitute, he'd get himself a pair of itchy nuts. But that's beside the point. Am I allowed to swear?
We don't mind.
It's compulsory.
Well, all right, it's in the context of the show, really. It's just one of the bands appearing at Glastonbury this year is called Holy Fuck. I just wondered what the team in the studio made of this.
Well, if people sit in the audience and go, holy fuck, then they suppose they've got the right reaction, haven't they?
Quite right, quite right. Well, I'm going to drift off now back into the other realms and finish my game of Scrabble with John Lennon.
Thank you, John.
Cheers, John. Take care. Sorry, cut him off. There we go. On the phone, hello.
Quality.
Oh, this is me this time.
Oh, hello, Leslie.
Hiya, how are you?
I'm all right, darling. How are you?
Oh, God, I've been drinking all afternoon. I can't get the bloody internet on.
Oh, that's a shame, isn't it?
No, we should.
Tommy Boyd there.
Yeah, yeah, we should actually explain. Leslie is our resident dietary expert.
I've heard about Leslie on the web.
Oh, you have?
I've heard about Leslie. I've picked up a little bit about his activities on the internet. Hello, Liz, an honour to speak to you, sir.
Hi, yes, I'm not very happy with you, to be honest, Tommy.
I'm not very happy with you either, actually. I made up that stuff about being impressed.
Well, I hope so. Well, because a few years back, I was living in a caravan, and you did a show on gypsies where you trashed them on talk radio, and a lady called up to defend the gypsies, and you made her cry.
Now, I'm
bloody good show, Tom.
Oh, I see. I made a lady cry about gypsies.
No, well, was she a gypsy?
After she cried, he sipped his coffee and he went, all in a day's work.
Did I do that? I don't remember that. Did I do that? Was it a real call? Some of our calls were staged.
Anyway, how are you, Tommy?
I've never been better, actually. Thank you for asking, Leslie. Today is the day. And
it's good. Yeah. You're not drinking anything with acid in it. You've not got a beer, have you?
Well, the guys have organised some Fosters, which is fantastic. And are you on the sauce yourself, Leslie, or are you...?
I was on cider earlier. You know that longbow stuff? Yeah. Oh, bloody hell. Well, I'm just feeling the hangover, but the reason I'm calling tonight is I'm going to be in Birmingham next weekend, and I'm wondering... I've got nowhere to stay. I'm wondering if Alan Caddick could put me up for the night. you know, I'll take him out for some beers and, you know, if we get on, if there's a bit of chemistry there, you know.
But, Leslie, you can't be encouraging Alan to drink alcohol. I mean, I thought it was all green drinks for you and nothing else. I'm a bit disappointed to hear you're on the cider today, mate.
Well, excuse me, I'm not on the weight loss challenge, you are.
No, but you like, you know, don't practice, or you've got to practice what you preach, mate, you know?
I've seen your videos, Leslie, and you damn well should be.
Excuse me, this time last year I was 21 stone, 14 pounds.
Right, and now, and this time this year it's 21 stone and what?
I'm 14 stone, 3 pounds.
Hang on a minute, 21 stone and 14 pounds, isn't that 22 stone, but it's just a nicer way of saying it, isn't it?
Oh, bugger you, yes he is.
Cheers, Leslie. Much, take Leslie. Care, ta-da.
That's a bye.
Bye. Swinging off the hook tonight,
yeah.
Yeah, fantastic.
See what the presence of Mr. Boyd does for us?
How do you get a fat lass into the sack?
Cake?
Yeah.
No,
a
piece of cake.
Yeah. All right. My mate Sid, he's had his ID stolen, so now he's just...
Yeah, very good.
That's all right, though, isn't it?
Yeah. Who's on the phone?
Go on.
No, they've gone.
They hung up when I answered. That's a shame.
Yeah.
There we go. Try that one. Hello? No, that was hung up as well. Yeah. That's a shame, isn't it? On the phone, hello?
Literally, I would say yes, but my housemate might have something to say about it.
No, your mum and dad, then?
No, my housemate.
Oh, yeah?
No, because when I'm at the show, I'm at my mum and dad, but most of the time I live on my own with a housemate in Quinton.
Oh, right, okay.
You live on your own with a housemate?
But, come in tonight, but sports on a summer holiday.
Yeah, last sport tonight, Alan, yeah.
No, it's summer holiday.
Oh, he's doing the summer holiday already.
Oh, you're not doing it tonight?
I'm doing the summer holiday all from this week, Matt.
Brilliant. Okay, well, in that case...
As we discussed on Facebook...
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, as we discussed on Facebook, I said, make tonight your last one, and Tommy's in, so make it good. So what you've actually done is done nothing.
Because you gave
easy for you to say, Alan.
Let Thomas
quit. Right. I'm sorry, Alan, you're making absolutely no sense, but I do have to... Yeah, that'll do.
Yeah, thanks, Alan.
I do have to say that Leslie taking Alan out drinking is just a sex crime waiting to happen.
It is, isn't it? Hello?
Hello?
Hello.
Is Tommy there, please?
Yes.
Tommy, did you get the Paul McCartney CD in the Daily Mail last week?
It's never been off the turntable.
It is shit. Fucking shit. Paul McCartney is fucking shit.
He's the greatest musician who's ever lived, mate.
He is a fucking scout.
In the years to come, they will recognise that Mozart didn't come up to his hip.
He will nick your fucking trainers.
Maybe, but I'll bet he could get a fucking good tune out of them.
Thank you very much for that. 01243 55 60 60. 01243 55 60 60. Back with more after this.
You're on the air, Susan, you know that.
I know I am. And I wanted to ask, you were talking about democracy in your last call.
Yeah.
What are your restrictions on this station? What can you and can't you say?
Well, I'll tell you, Susan, as far as I know, the laws of the land apply, so I can't...
What about the laws of broadcasting?
There are no such thing. If I wanted to say I could say it. I mean, I wouldn't say it, but because somebody may have apoplexy, but that's how free it is.
The James Whale Radio Show, Tuesday, 6 till 10pm UK time, only on Play2UK.
Hi, Steve Phillips here. Are you fed up with going out on a Friday and Saturday night? All the restaurants seem the same? All the movies you've seen before? Well, change your image. Stay in on a Friday and Saturday night from 10 o'clock and we'll have some fun. I'll play you the best 80s tunes on the internet as part of the All 80s Weekend. Bring a pizza, bring a bottle of wine. We are going to have a party together.
This is not the Tommy Boyd Show with Stu and Matt on Play2UK. Beware, the content of this show may offend.
I've got till and let's 8, you know that.
Yeah, that's right. Fine. Is that a direction from the wife, or...?
No, we've got the youngest, he's coming home, he wants his tea, and he gets in at 8:30, and we all like to sit down together if we can, as a school.
Family should do
a
that.
A family, which we weren't able to do when we were doing this. How long did we do this from start-up? About 6 months, wasn't it?
No, it was August to December.
August, September, October, November, December. 4 months. Yeah.
It
got in the way a little bit of a Saturday evening, but it was... Ah, I loved every minute of it. Yeah. And, you know, see if we can do something similar again in the...
Yeah.
In the sort of...
But our door has always been open for you here. Yeah.
How's James? How's my mate James, who I have known... Oh, God, on and off, I suppose, 30 bloody years.
Really?
He's always been that brilliant.
Yeah. He was very good on Tuesday. I was here doing the old IT.
He's always been.
Involved, you know? So, brilliant.
You know, if he was American, he'd be a billionaire. I mean, he's a millionaire, obviously, but he'd be a billionaire, you know, media superstar. Mm. This country doesn't give talk radio presenters the status that I think they deserve. Instead, they give it to motor mouths like Chris Moyles, who's very good. But he's a motor-mouth disc jockey.
Yeah.
Get him onto anything, you know, requiring several brain cells, and he'll swear, blow a raspberry, and go into the disc. Whereas James, you know, has been sustaining really entertaining, intelligent debate, and some bollocks as well, because that's James, you know, brilliantly for about 30 years. And he's just not got the credit for it that he deserves.
Chris Moyles wrote the foreword for his book.
Did he?
Almost famous or something, yeah.
Was it?
Yeah, Chris Moyles wrote for his book. But,
there you are.
It was very good. I mean, Tuesday night was very much just a welcome back. Glad to have you on the air and glad you can be slightly freer with a lot of the emails. But look, yeah, very enjoyable.
Yeah, and as I say, I think it will be really interesting to see whether he wants to take, how he takes advantage of the extra freedoms and opportunities that you have broadcasting, first of all, to a worldwide audience. Seriously, I mean, all radio stations have a website. But how many people in Osaka do you think are listening to Radio Git FM in Lowestoft? Huh? Probably one, actually.
Yeah, there's always someone, isn't there?
When I was at Southern Counties, the BBC, they had a listener. He used to email me in the middle of the afternoon from Wisconsin. And he listened to the BBC, Southern Counties Radio, all his waking life.
Wow.
And I said, well, in the end, I phoned him and I said, how did this come about? He said, well, I got on the internet and I saw a program, Your Top Gear, in which your presenters came and they did the travel reports for BBC Southern Counties Radio. He said, and I just decided to still listening. He said, now I'm fascinated. I said, do you understand any of it? The roads and the issues and everything? No, he said, I don't. He said, but one of the reasons I like listening to it is because it's no call to action. I'm not made to work.
Yeah.
He said, it's a really good point. He said, if I listen to the news on my local radio station, these are things I should be concerned about.
Yeah.
I ought to be worried. I should have an opinion. Otherwise, I am a failure as a human being. He said, but when I listen to Southern Counties Radio, it's irrelevant to me.
Yeah.
So I don't actually feel as though I'm working. It's a good point, isn't it?
It's a very good point. I mean, I think we worry too much in this country, don't we?
We worry too much.
I mean, if you're a worrier, do not read the Daily Mail.
Yeah. Ah, well, I used to work for them.
I like a good worry myself.
My parents love
it.
Of course you do. Of course you do.
You're
well
a woman.
I'm not worrying. You know, there's something wrong. I've got to worry about something.
This is what the Daily Mail worked out some decades ago. And when you write for the Daily Mail, you're now required
to have your article pass this test? Will it upset anger, cause anger in, or worry all of our readers? It's got to happen. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I was wondering, because I was watching the telly late last night, and Rob Knox, a young boy, he was a young actor, got killed last night, or the night before. And they were reading out the papers, and they actually said, Harry Potter star slaughtered,
yeah.
And this kind of stuff. And I'm like, well, A, he's not. Mm-hmm. Yes, it's tragic, but wait a second, there's front page news, and I'm thinking, hyperboling.
It's almost as if...
Calm down. You know.
It's almost as if Daniel Radcliffe got murdered.
Yeah.
Harry Potter star, I think he's got a walk-on part.
Yeah, that's what it said, wasn't it? A walk-on part in the latest film or
and
something
like
that.
And that's not saying that his life is any less important
of course.
Like that, but the way they put it, everyone's like, oh no, what will happen to the next Harry Potter film?
Certainly. Let's take a call, Stu. Lines are busy.
Now, hello.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Just been wondering if you're interested in our internet service provider.
No, thank you. It's working fine. Cheers. I'm on the phone. Hello.
Play the fucking jingle!
Oh, hang on a minute. Let's get that one, and it's that one.
Better be good, Alan.
Sunday night.
Time. He's timed it exactly right to the end of the sports bulletin.
Yeah, I'd have that. I'd have that on radio anywhere. I'd have that as my. That's how I'd like to see sports done.
That was brilliant. Thank you, Alan.
Cheers, Alan.
Thank you. Very good.
That is how sports should be done. That's how news should be done. What I've been angling for is sometimes at 8 o'clock in the morning saying, any news? And instead of the usual pom-pom music and the this followed by this.
Yeah.
And then this. They go, not a lot, no, forget it.
same as 15 minutes ago, Tom.
Most mornings, that's all there is. There's nothing.
It must get pretty boring doing it. I guess, because I've listened a few times and I've emailed you a couple of times, I've been on the train and stuff like that. One of the biggest bugbears I always had with radio in the mornings is 15 minutes, news and travel.
Yeah.
And you just get into something. I used to listen to Nick Ferrari at one point in time.
Yeah.
And I switched off just purely simply because he'd just get into a conversation with someone and it was news and travel.
Yeah.
And whilst I appreciate the breakfast show needs news and travel, it's all everybody, isn't it?
Well, I say, have the news when something happens.
Exactly.
You know, and rush in with it.
Yeah.
Everybody does the news. Every single radio station in the country stops for the news at the top of the hour and they do 3 minutes of it and it's all identical.
Yeah. Well, it's all the same stuff from
IRL. I cannot understand... The thinking there.
Yeah.
I just don't get it.
Well, it's like on TV when they all take advert breaks at the same time. All you want to do is flick around and find a channel that doesn't have an advert break in it, isn't it? You know?
Can I tell you something really interesting about that? You know, like you think if you've been doing something for a long time, you almost know everything.
Yeah.
Well, I reached that point years ago in broadcasting, but I'm constantly being reminded that other people are a lot cleverer than I am. So I was talking to some kids who said that they liked to watch Transformers on the telly, which is a cartoon series on the BBC, and then watch the commercials that followed it, because that would tell you what kind of Transformer toys were available to buy. So they'd watch the programme, and then they'd get the information from the commercial about which Transformer toys there were. And I said to them, fellas, nice idea, but can I just point out, Transformers is on the BBC, and the BBC don't do commercials.
Mm.
They went, no... They said, but what ITV, what the advertisers do, is they work out when the programmes are on the BBC, and they then put the adverts on ITV immediately after the programme ends on the BBC.
Oh.
So to find out what products are available for the programme we watched on the BBC, we just tuned straight over to ITV. Now, I didn't know that. The BBC didn't know that. ITV didn't bloody know that, right? But the advertisers and the kids knew that.
Yeah.
We'll see. It works. No, who's on the phone?
You've gone.
No
they've
one.
Gone.
They've gone that one there.
We need to rattle through some of these.
One. Hello.
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 It's Victor here. How are you?
Hello, Victor. How are you?
Very well. Can I speak to Tommy, please?
Go ahead.
Tommy.
Great yes, where are you from, Victor?
Great to see you back again, if only for a short time. I wanted to ask you how you feel, what you think about how the boys are carrying on your legacy. Are you happy with it? Is there anything...
Yeah, no, I'm very happy with it. I think that Matt, right from the start, showed a particular aptitude for this type of radio. If I ever hear him talking over the intro to a disc and coming right up to the vocals with the same cadence as the song, I'll shoot him, because he's born to do this. And Stuart, I mean, it's a revelation, because this is a very difficult type of radio, and even though he still can't tech op, he's certainly he's doing it, doing a brilliant, brilliant job. So I'm very proud of these lads, because I'm going to tell everybody when they're ultra famous that I invented them.
And you're quite, you can have that.
Yeah, well,
quite welcome.
And you did. It's true. So you're proud of everything. Have you got any pointers or tips how you would like this show to continue?
Well, I think that it's important that the presenters and the contributors continue to see themselves on a level playing field. Because it always hacks me off, this idea that you have broadcasters up here and all little people down here, you know.
The great unwashed over there.
Yeah, who can come on sometimes and say some things, but not a lot, because they're not very interesting, really. So I like that.
Do you think we did less zoo after you left? Started to do less of the zoo than when you were here?
Well,
would you like to see us do more in the future?
I think if it works, do it again. And if it doesn't work twice in a row, then don't do it anymore and deny you ever did it in the first place.
Yeah,
deny all knowledge.
Rule 8 of radio is take chances and run scared, and it's my favourite rule, actually. Because on radio, on television, you can't try something out because it costs too much, £25,000 for half an hour. But on radio, you know, you can just try something for half an hour. Try anything, almost anything lawful.
Pretty much.
And if you think, well, there's something there, then next week do it again, a little bit better. And then...
Fantastic.
Yeah, that's what I say. What do you say, mate? What do you polls reckon?
What do I think? Well, yeah. I think that what has happened afterwards was really good. They really, in my opinion, they carry on this, what you started very well. Obviously, there's only one thing which they lack, which you have, and that is they're not... In a sense, it's because, you know, old, you know, I don't want to call you old, but you're obviously older than they are, yeah, and therefore you have the experience and the also the journalistic incision of mind, which perhaps they don't yet have. And so, you know, for example, there are some things which they cannot do that you can do. This is, I don't mean to be mean by that, but it's the truth.
No.
Yeah, for example, you know, I want to give you an example. Many years ago, when I was listening to you on the radio station, you started to talk about Kierkegaard, and you started to talk about the philosophy where people should start to think about more about others in terms of what their intention is and about themselves, about what they actually do, and what most people do is actually the opposite. And I was entranced by this, and this sort of talking about philosophy, talking about very intellectual matters, this is what I think is missing a little bit, because these guys are brilliant, they're great talents, but there's one that they still is not completely what would be if you were here the whole time. But still, I'm very happy with what they do. I don't want to criticize in any way, because they're doing a very good job, the best they can do. And I think it's a unique product on the internet. I think it's the best there is.
Yeah, you're quite right, Victor. And I think, you know, it became apparent in the first show or two after Tommy left. And we actually, I think, said on air, we're not Tommy Boyd. We haven't got all these experiences of showbiz TV lifestyle, and we can't throw off an anecdotes, which you're quite good at doing. We are who we are, and we're honest, and I think that's the main thing about it. We're honest,
yes.
And we try
yes.
our best.
Yes, hey, that you make, I think you've gone right to the heart of it there, and I wonder whether Victor agrees. You only find things out as you go through life, and actually, Victor, as you go through life, the more you come to realise how little you know. And so it becomes a process of actually shedding a lot of the things that you thought you knew, or at least you thought were important, because they're kind of getting in the way of the one or two little things that really do matter. And honesty, as Matt has said, is right up there with those things. And thank you for mentioning Soren Kierkegaard. I'd completely forgotten about him.
You used to talk quite a bit about it. I used to love the way you talk about him.
Well, Kierkegaard, have you read Either Or?
Well, I was wondering, one of the things I want to ask you is where to start, because I was thinking of reading him. I've meant to do it ever since you first mentioned it about 8 years ago.
He's very difficult to penetrate, like Wittgenstein, who is utterly impenetrable, considered the best philosopher of the 20th century, but he is unreadable, because instead of writing using words, he just uses numerical formula. Which is mathematical formula, which is utterly impenetrable, frankly. But Kierkegaard's basic... what happened to Kierkegaard was his father was a shepherd.
Right.
And one day, his father cursed God because it was pouring with rain, he was freezing cold, and one of his sheep wandered off and got lost, and he was going to get into trouble for it. And he looked at the heavens, Kierkegaard's dad, and he cursed God. And then for the rest of his life, he believed that he was going to be damned. And he was a terrified, sad and unhappy man because of what this religious fear had done to him. And Soren Kierkegaard, the boy, was driven to right this wrong, that his dear father should spend the rest of his life believing he was going to go to hell because he cursed God on a hilltop in Denmark. So Soren Kierkegaard got down to trying to work out what it is to be a human being. Forget religion, he said. What is it to be a human being? And he wrote a book called Either Or, in which he tried to help everybody understand what he's seen, which is that you can be a little bit mad as long as you're a little bit boring.
Right.
You can be a little bit spiritual, mm-hmm. as well as long as you're also a little bit of an atheist, you know, as in two fingers the church. So he said it's all about balance. But then he said, this is what you are, because we all wonder what we are and whether there's a point. And he said, I don't know whether there's a point. He said, but you know, like you're yourself, but you can also watch yourself. You know, like you watch yourself doing things, don't you? And you think, Stuart, what are you doing?
Kind of yourself a mental
all the time. Yeah. And Kierkegaard said this, the definition of the self is not the self, nor is it the self that watches the self. What you are is the relationship you have between yourself and the self that watches you. And it's important that the self that watches you likes you, loves you, helps you, and isn't constantly condemning you or being harsh to you.
How does this fit in with what Freud say about the superego?
Okay.
You're getting very philosophical tonight, isn't it?
I happen to believe in Freud. A lot of people don't, but I'm the only person who's read the Analysis of Dreams, which is his fourth book.
I read it.
And isn't it entertaining?
Very good. In good German, too.
I'm afraid I only read the translation. I wonder if it's the
brilliant.
Same.
Being very, very silly, aren't I? Sorry good. About that.
No, I don't mind. I can reduce Freud to what he said that I appreciate. He said, happiness is love and work.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll go along with that.
Brilliant. Victor, thanks a lot, mate.
Thank you very much.
Take care.
I thought he was a character.
Victor?
No. Yes.
Yeah.
Is he?
Maybe.
Right. Maybe. I mean, I wasn't sure. I started to go to speak to him in Polish, you see. Only to show off.
I think he's
speaking a bit of Polish.
Oh, right, okay.
Oh, nowadays.
Yeah, well, that much is true. Yeah, nowadays. Yeah, yeah. Poland Joe says hi, by the way. He hasn't been on for a while, but it's, you remember the American Polish Yank?
Show, yeah, I missed that. Well, remember him?
Yeah.
I've been singing his praises all four hours of broadcasting.
We've got some bills to pay.
We've got some bills to pay. We've got some calls to have, and we've got a video that we want to play you, which one of our contributors has very kindly put together this week.
Just waiting for an encoding to finish.
An encoding to finish. Okay, so we've got 15 minutes for that encoding to finish.
It's good. Back more after this.
Passion. Discover yours. Passion is a brand new shopping experience for adventurous adults. a mix of art and entertainment, creating a sensual adult show. 24th and 25th of May 2008 at Earl's Court. Grab your ticket for £15 before the event at www.passion-uk.com. Be tempted. Explore. Passion. Discover yours.
Want £100 off of the cost of your next holiday? One4 Travel are offering an unbelievable £100 discount off of all holiday bookings. Whether you want to visit Turkey, Bulgaria, Croatia, Egypt, Cyprus or Spain, One4 Travel have a fantastic range of hotels to suit every holiday need. All you need to do to get your £100 discount on top of the everyday exceptional prices is call now on 0871 664 1405 or visit the website at www.14travel.co.uk.
It's not the Tommy Boyd Show with Matt and Stu, only on Play2UK. Beware, the content of this show may offend.
19 minutes left to the Boyd. 01243 55 60 60. Don't forget you can email us at studio@playradiouk.com as well. We've got a couple. M. Williams says, what's the difference between Arthur Scargill and Gary Glitter?
What's the difference between Arthur Scargill and Gary Glitter?
Arthur Scargill hasn't touched a miner's helmet in over 30 years. This is welcome back, Tom. Yeah. If you want to get on the cameras, www.nttbs.com is where you can find the cameras under the watch link. You can also find a bunch of listen links and all the details of how to contact the show there.
Indeed.
How you doing, Tom? All right?
Yes, I'm doing very well. The guys were just making, offering notes up during the commercial break. I like that.
Good.
Keeping the product polished.
Yeah.
Attending to small details one at a time. That's the way to do it, man.
Absolutely.
Yep.
I wonder where you'll be in, say, 20 years' time, you guys. Do you ever think about that?
Sometimes.
I think
what
possibly.
What will you be? Early 40s, will you?
In 20 years' time, I'll be 50.
Will you? Okay. Where do you think you'll be?
I think I'll possibly be in an imaginary cell at the Ofcom prison.
Nah. Do you think about it?
Do I think about Ofcom?
Yeah, I think one of the things about being young that is hard is that you have this massive piece of territory which you're supposed to explore and claim. It's a real burden.
Yeah.
And one of the nice things about having all that behind you is that, you know, you don't have that obligation anymore to fulfil your life.
Yeah.
Which is a huge obligation, which we're given by teachers and by the world and everything. You know, you must strive and you must get these exam results because you must do the best for yourself you possibly can. And how else will you get a job in an insurance firm if you don't do all that kind of crud? So just, be the best you can, but
Mrs. Stewart will be, we will have a 20-year-old by then, hopefully, in 20 years' time. So
The milkman got her up.
Thank you. Yeah, the milkman. The milkman came round while I was at work and sorted her out, you know.
Do you remember the bonk?
Eh?
Do you remember the actual bonk?
I know which one it was, yeah.
Go on.
Well,
it was
a nighttime event one evening at home, yeah.
Did it feel special? Did you know that a person would happen? Were you trying?
Yeah, we were trying, so.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
So. Good.
Yeah.
I would like to read out an email.
It's very scary when you look at me like that, Tom. As if to say, you really want to know the details, but...
Well, I think that, you know, you think it's an enormous thing.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable, you know. And one of my favourite Harry Enfield sketches was these two sort of simple people sitting on a park bench, boy, girl, Harry Enfield, and what's her name?
Kathy...
Burke.
And he just goes, She had a tummy ache, and we took her to the hospital! And the person came out of her! And it's had to come home with us!
That's Wayne and Waynetta Slob, isn't it? Yeah.
No, it's not actually.
No, it wasn't.
It's a really beautiful, surreal nugget of a thing, but isn't it ridiculous being a human being? We do that to each other.
Yeah.
And a person comes out of your wife.
Yeah.
And we spend most of our lives pushing dead animals into a hole in our face. If you start looking at what it is to be a human being for too long, you go even madder.
Nothing wrong with being a bit mad. I want to read out
an email.
I want to sort of pay attention to this. James Whale started on Tuesday night. Hi guys, great station and show. Started listening when James Whale was on Tuesday. Keep up the good work, John. Thank you very much for choosing to listen to us, John. After being a James Whale fan, we do appreciate anybody who listens to James Whale joining in, contributing to the show. They're all very welcome. It's a little bit more random, but hopefully you'll enjoy it.
Yeah, got a load of more phone calls if you want to take.
Yeah, let's take some calls. Yeah,
on the phone, hello.
Good evening, I shall now read the news.
Is there any?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
just reading the news.
That is good.
Very good indeed.
Thank you.
Yeah, I'll tell you, it's brilliantly performed. Because that one actually goes, I'm just going to read a letter here from a listener. And the other one is, my favourite one is, you must do that, you know this one. What is it? Hang on, Chico. It's a disc show. And you go, well, I just had a very unusual request from a lady in Lowestoft, so I'm going to be away bang on time tonight.
That's very good.
On the telephone, hello. Yes, that's you.
No, they're gone.
They've gone as well. Let's try that one.
That's
on
line
the phone,
3.
Hello? No, try this one then. Line 4, hello.
You know what really grinds my gears?
You know what really grinds my gears?
Last night, you were in a song contest. It's supposed to be about popularity of a tune. So why use block voting to for a political vote and make it the Balkan who give 12 points to each other, Greece giving 12 to Cyprus, Cyprus giving 12 to Greece?
It's not a song contest, Alan. It is a show of political strength. The whole point of the Eurovision Song Contest is to give an opportunity for once downtrodden countries to feel the kind of camaraderie and love for their fellow neighbours that they were denied during the Soviet bloc domination of them. Now they have an opportunity to feel that they can express their own culture, linking arms with nations that border them so that they can show off their cross-border culture, their long and proud history, their musical heritage. Their cheesy winks at the camera. And in any case, before it was them, it was us with the Viking Empire, the Swedes voting for Norway, Norway voting for Finland, Finland voting for Iceland, us voting for Ireland, Ireland voting for us. Is that still going on? Of course not. Oh, wait a minute. Yes, it is.
Well, no, it isn't, because Ireland didn't get in because they had that stupid Turkey.
They still got a vote and they voted for us.
They voted for us.
Really?
Yeah, oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Well, the thing is, we came last again.
The song was rubbish.
It was all right. You're telling me Russia's was better?
Russia's song, technically, was a better song.
Yeah.
But wait. It was still better than Spain.
Yeah.
By a long shot.
Okay, well, right. If we keep coming last every year, regardless of what we do, why don't we just pull out?
Why do we carry on? Because Russia hasn't won in the past. Well, how many times has Russia been in this competition? The first time they've won is last night.
We don't pull out because the BBC signed a very long contract with Eurovision and it cost them a lot of money. Mm.
I think I want to enter it next year.
The programme is utterly delicious and fascinating. It's art because it makes us think, what is going on here? Why are these people voting in this way? Is that right or is that wrong? We think, look at these songs and we go, should that win? It's ridiculous. Should that win? It's sublime. But ridiculous sometimes beats sublime. So which one do I want to win? And isn't it mostly about looking up girls' skirts anyway?
Yeah,
for God's sake.
Cleavage and that.
So, yeah. You know, and that's just true. I mean, that Ukrainian entry. Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean. Ah. Oh. So, yeah. long may it remain, and long may we come last.
Yes.
Yeah,
and let them kick our butt, because we deserve our butts being kicked.
We do. Who's on the phone?
Is it me? Is that me there?
Yeah, line one, hello.
I'm just phoning because I'm a very big fan of Mr. Boyd. I believe he was on the show tonight. I'm not at home being able to listen. I'm at work at the moment, working. That's what I'm doing. I'm work. Hang on a moment. Get on the floor and put your hands behind your fucking back right now, you bastard. Sorry, hang on a moment. Put them behind your back now. This is fucking loaded. Sorry, I'm going to have to go. This guy's putting up a little bit of a fight.
Yes, is
Sorry.
That Robert Nyrak you're still trying to do away with, or what?
Right, say that.
Yeah, go on.
No, sorry, go on.
Carry on.
What an extraordinary story that was. Have you come across tonight?
Fucking joke.
Are you all right there?
Who are you talking to?
Can you turn him up a bit? I can't hear him. I can tell there's somebody there.
Are you, listen, have a day off here.
No, I can't hear him now.
Can you hear me?
You're
fucking a man.
No, it's that. He's got a funny accent, I can tell that, but I don't know.
They're proper wankers, those. Yeah.
So what should we do? Should we,
Of the show are wankers. You're listening. Boring farts, I ain't got a fucking clue. I think they're charming wankers. But anyway, we'll get our points across eventually.
Well, go on then.
Oh, you're listening?
Oh, we've been listening to you for ages, Chris.
Can I ask you, please?
Yes.
Who's this I'm speaking to? Who's the interlocutor?
Stuart.
Are you taking the piss again, you pair?
Me? Take the piss out of you, Chris.
Who's Never. This?
It's too easy, mate.
Teresa. Hello, Teresa.
How are you, Chris?
Well, here, is the mass in now?
Yeah.
Where's the
bus. I want to speak to him. So I'm going to put
all
my
attention
into the piss in my stomach.
What do you want? What do you want to know?
What do I want?
Yeah, what do you want to know?
I told you it was a machine.
Go on, ask me anything you want. Anything you want. Ask me anything you want. I know everything.
I'll ask you.
Go on, go on, go on, go on, go on. Then I bet you can't ask me a question I don't know the answer to.
Oh, you think you're Tommy fucking Boyd?
Yeah, I am. I am. I am. Half of me is twice of you. Come on, come on. Ask me anything.
Come on,
come on.
That's anyway, yeah.
Come on, I'm from fucking Felton, mate. Come on! Come on! God, you start it, I'll finish it. If that's the best you've got, mate, you're in trouble.
The best
I've got. It's a great line, that. It's a great line, that.
I'm going to speak to
I saw a bloke hit in a nightclub. This bloke just came up to him and he just went bang like that in this bloke's face. And the sound of cracking bone and blood and everything was. He really hit him.
Nice.
But the bloke who was hit, he just turned really slowly to the bloke who'd hit him and he just went, if that's the best you've got, mate, you're in trouble.
Quality.
It's good, isn't it?
It is very good. Have we got Chappa's video?
We have a video from a contributor.
Okay.
Who would like to...
You might want to go around there to get a better view.
No, I can see it.
Can you see that?
I can see it.
Okay. So...
I can see it.
This
He's
is
an intelligent looking lad. This is, well, I'm about to be proved
this
wrong.
This is the real Peter Chapman.
If I can get the camera to stay steady. Hang on a minute. Let's do that.
Who's the not real Peter Chapman?
There we go.
Somebody else.
Okay. You ready for this one?
Hello, and welcome to the end of week 14 of the Play Radio UK Weight Loss Challenge. Now, last week proved to be an unlucky week 13 for myself, as I surrendered the lead to Stuart Heron. But the big news this week is that James Whale finally made his debut on Play Radio. The listeners were in a frenzy, calling in, kissing his ass like he's the best thing ever. One person even phoned up and sang a jingle to him down the phone. A jingle?
Coming up shortly.
It was vomit-inducing. These callers should be thoroughly ashamed of themselves, for they have shown a complete lack of respect to the king of talk radio, who has returned to the Not the Tommy Boyd Show this evening. I am, of course, referring to Aaron Weedle. It's great to have you back, buddy. The show has been nothing without you. Now, as we all know, Tommy Boyd used to present children's TV. And although he had to wear many ridiculous costumes, he did get to interview many great people, including our favourite band here on the Not the Tommy Boyd Show. Let's take a look at the footage.
Did you pick a card, any card?
Do you need your washing up for days on end? I must tell the truth and say yes.
Do you?
I never wash up.
It doesn't matter after a while, does it?
No, because you can just...
Really?
Well, if you're happy dinner, you can give it to the dog and he'll lick it clean. So you're all right.
Or if you had egg on one day and then the next day you fancy chips, if you put the chips on the egg plate, you get double the enjoyment.
Yeah.
We should get Fuzzbox on the show.
aren't they unique? They are, though. They are unique.
As smooth as ever, Mr. Boyd even managed to attract one of the band members.
Very show busy thing of going, darlings and things like that.
I'm jealous. So come on, Tommy, you can tell us. Did she have a fuzzy box? To be honest, my lasting memory of the Wide Awake Club is not Tommy Boyd, it's actually of this person.
Michaela Strachan, you broke my heart. Michaela Strachan, you tore me apart. I used to want to be a vet. Just so I'd see you one day. You put meaning in like a day.
And finally, my weekly videos wouldn't be complete without mentioning my favourite Play Radio employee. So, I'd just like to say, Matt Hollick, I think you're an absolute...
With the guns over the... That's it, there we go. I guess we must have the weight loss coming up later on.
It's a mystery. Ladies and gentlemen, the real Peter Chapman.
Very good.
Very entertaining.
And, I'm very jealous, by the way, because the one that kissed you in Fuzzbox was the one that I used to really like when I was a kid.
Yeah, what do you want to know?
Has she got a fuzzy box? Just pretend the wife's not in the other room, be right.
I didn't actually go to bed with any of them.
Oh, right, okay. You see, this is our show tune.
Ah, hence.
Hence, yeah.
I don't know what hence means. What does hence mean?
Henceforth.
Hence is one of those stupid names, words, isn't it?
That, stupid
entry, well, I use words like that to end conversations, because I thought that conversation was ending anyway, so I said hence, rather than respond.
It's back to normal service then, Tom telling me I'm crap. Thanks, mate.
No! No, when you're crap, I'll tell you, but you haven't been crap this evening yet.
Thanks. I've got 6 minutes to blow it. 5 minutes to blow it. You see? Yeah. There we go.
It's all right. It only takes you 3 minutes, according to your wife, who's now pregnant.
Oh, very funny, yes. 01243 55 60 60 is the number. Lines are engaged at the moment. And, no, we've got a tune for that, mate.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not thinking
straight. No, you're not thinking straight, are you?
No.
See, the production hasn't got that much better time.
The only thing I'd suggest you develop is a better way of communicating without holding up pieces of paper.
Yeah.
Because it, two things. One, you've got to write it out, and that's difficult, because none of us have got very good writing.
Hey, you ain't kidding.
Yeah. And the other thing is, you know, when you're reading a held-up note, nobody's actually listening to what's being said.
No.
Yeah.
So I think, I don't know how you're going to do it, but one way of doing it is to be absolutely honest and say everything that you...
Okay.
Say everything that needs saying.
Yeah.
Busy the phones, pink sunshine while Tommy leaves is something you could talk about on air.
Yeah.
Well, I was just thinking, do we play a tune while we say goodbye to Tommy?
Well, so talk about it on air. Rather than kick
him out of the studio and say see you later and carry on with the show. And I said busy the phones because...
No, that's fine. I'm just saying, I'd have it out on air.
Well, I don't mind.
When I worked at Radio 5, that we had two wavelengths, 909 and 693, yeah?
Yeah.
And we used to do a show and we'd interview people. And then we play a disc, and then we do a sports report, and then we do a disc. And during the disc, we'd have really good discussions. The producer would go to me, do you want to talk to Mike Gatting, who's England cricket captain? And I go, not really, because he's boring. I'd rather talk to a fan at the game, on the terrace, about how the game is going.
Yeah.
Because I think that's more interesting than the usual crap that you get from England cricket captains. Then we go back off the disc, and I'd be back broadcasting. Saying, well, in just a moment, we're hoping to go across to Lords, where England captain Mike Gatting is waiting to have a word with us, and we might also have an opportunity to have a chat with one of the fans who are there enjoying the game. And that was crap.
Yeah.
And so I said to them, why don't we do this, right? We'll put out the proper radio show on 693, whatever it is, and on 909, we'll leave the mics up all the time. Yeah. In the studio, over the record, and in the gallery where you guys are arguing the toss. And I said, which show do you think everybody will listen to?
Yeah, that's a good point.
Go on, really? There's no contest, is there?
Do you know what it is?
There's no contest.
I'll tell you why. It's, you know, if you hunt around on Sky sometimes using the little manual tune button on the Sky boxes, you can pick up some of the feeds from the football grounds without all the presentation crap. So you just get the cameras and the presenters doing their checks and this, that, and the other. Much more interesting than watching Richard Keys and Andy Green.
It's real.
Mm-hmm. Isn't it? We've got one more call who's been waiting. Oh, it's been waiting on hold for 13 minutes and has now just rung off. But
that's fine.
We've got one more.
Okay.
You want to take one more, Tom?
Take one more.
I'd love to.
They've rung off as well.
Hang on. In that case, I'm going to ring off.
Yeah.
Lovely to have you again, Tom.
Physically, yeah. I really enjoyed that. Yeah. That was great.
It's been great, mate. All right. Take care.
It was really good.
Keeping the Mr. Boy
show very warm there.
So Tommy's going, which means pretty much normal service resumed. We're going to take an ad break and have a song.
Yeah. Take care. See you tomorrow.
Did you know you can now have your windows at home or at work professionally cleaned for as little as £1.50 per window without damaging the environment? Window and Wheelie do it greener and cleaner with state-of-the-art pure water technology using no detergents, chemicals or ladders, with the added bonus that your windows stay cleaner for longer, leaving you more time for business or pleasure. Our operatives may be cleaning in your area right now, so give the Wheelie Bin and Window Cleaning Company a call on 08702 437691 or visit windowandwheelie.co.uk for more details.
Play Radio UK have teamed up with Virgin Wines to offer you a massive £20 discount off your favourite wines. Visit playradiouk.com/virginwines to start saving now and get your favourite wines delivered to your door. Play Radio UK and Virgin Wines for people who love their wine and a great deal. PlayRadioUK.com/Virgin Wines.
Find out how your business can reach over 3.5 million clients right now by emailing sales@PlayRadioUK.com or call 01243 556 285. PlayRadioUK.com. Internet radio your way.
Broadcasting live to the UK. News, information, entertainment, and the best music from the past 40 years. This is Play2UK. This is not the Tommy Boyd Show with Stu and Matt on Play2UK. Beware, the content of this show may offend.
That'll be us again then. Hang on.
Marvellous. I like that.
That was Isolde again?
Yes.
That one was recorded earlier on because we obviously didn't want to get interrupted while we were moving everybody around and what have you.
Exactly.
It's just gone 8 o'clock. Thank you very much to Mr. Boyd coming in this evening and sitting in for an hour. It's brilliant. Aaron's in the studio.
Good evening!
Isolde's here, Joe's here, Matt's off doing something or the other, saying goodbyes and what have you. And
having a pee.
Having a pee and all that lot.
I'm giving up on this computer, I have to say.
Oh yeah, I would as well, yeah. Yeah.
All that money.
I would too. It's 01243 55 60 60 on the phones, or 0208 123 1088 if you want to get through on that as well. Let's try line one. Hello. Alan. No, we've had a good confabulation during the week, and we've.
Yeah, but when I was banned.
Okay, that'll do. See you later, Alan.
Alan,
we're not bothered, Alan. We don't care, mate. We don't care.
Okay, Alan, there's extenuating circumstances that were different between your outburst.
Yeah, get
okay, Alan. I gotta go. All right, cheers, mate.
Okay, mate.
I love it at the end. Blah blah blah.
It's not very clear. It doesn't. It's not touch sensitive, is it?
It's because you're being too gentle.
I know.
My gentle bear.
Gentle touch.
My gentle bear, who I like to hug.
Line two, hello. Who's just hung up?
Right. I think. Right. No one actually knows what line they're on. So if we say you're on the hello on the phones, if all of you on the phone go hello.
Say hello, Matt.
Hello, Chris.
Nah, fuck off, you. I've been hanging on for fucking ever.
All right. Well, you fuck off then. If you want to be like. you're going to be arsey. Oh, is that yours?
Yes. Would you mind unplugging me?
Unplugging you?
Yes.
Oh, dear. Put a diaphragm in.
Where did
that come from?
Unplugging? G-Man. A plug.
Would you shave my coin?
No.
Okay.
No.
Well, just you're asking to be unplugged.
It helps if you do this one.
Would you shave my coin purse?
See, now he asked right. That's all right.
I wondered if I could speak to this week's special guest. Hi, Aaron.
Good evening, G-Man.
How the hell are you?
Oh, all right. How are you, sir?
Get yourself around the mic, Aaron.
It's not... Is it on?
Move
it is on.
Come on, look lively, young man.
I've got bags behind me. I don't
Oh, come on, Aaron.
I'm all right. Hello.
There isn't any bags down there, is there?
Hello, G-Man. How are you, sir?
I'm very well, thank you very much. So nice to hear you back where you belong.
Well, it's so nice to be back. G-Man, can you do me a favour?
Yeah?
Would you shave my coin purse?
I saw there's a wonderful clip on YouTube of the one he starts calling his mum and then just runs away at the end. It just made me laugh uncontrollably for no particular reason.
Somebody sent that to me on Facebook the other day.
I think it was me.
Oh, yes, it might have been. And I had to.
It was me, yeah.
I said to the wife, she was sitting next to me on the sofa when I looked at it, and I went, look, this is what you've got to look forward to. And he goes, mum, mum, mummy, mum, mum, Lois, 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 mummy, mum, 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 mum. And she's just looking at me, I said, you've got all that to look forward to.
And he goes, hi, and runs off.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, she goes, what? And he goes, hi, and runs off. Yeah, it's great.
Love it. Thank you.
I was watching an episode of Family Guy the other day, the one where they say the evil monkey's become a Jehovah's Witness and he holds out a Bible instead of pointing his finger. I was pissing myself.
That's brilliant. G-Man, what can I do for you, mate?
Well, I thought I'd just ring in. I thought I'd help you restart the topics because obviously, my the first day wonderfully.
Thank you.
I love it when he goes on his rants.
Yeah, it's good, isn't it?
I've missed that.
Yeah, it's been a while. Yeah.
Brilliant. Okay.
He doesn't do that in the mornings, obviously, when I've listened to him. He doesn't go off on his little rants. It's fantastic.
That's good, yeah. So what were the topics for this week, anybody want to remind
Freedom
me?
Of speech.
Freedom of speech.
Joe had a good one.
Did I?
Yes, you thingy person.
How do you know?
What?
Oh, God.
I don't have my computer.
Was it Al Fayed?
I've got a man.
Al
Fayed.
That wasn't me. That was Stu, actually.
All right, G-Man, what are they?
There's Mohammed Fayed. He now wants to move to Scotland if it becomes independent. Because obviously he can't get himself a British passport, so he could try and get a Scottish one.
Right.
That'd be one of the things.
Yeah.
What really grinds your gears about the fact that bus stops are only 50 feet apart? Oh. I have to agree with that one.
Will you hit that, please?
You know what really grinds my gears?
Right, the other day I was running late. For work, okay? Turn your media play down. The other day I was running late for work, right? And I was behind a bus. This bus stops every 30 metres or something like that, right? When it stops, no one gets on. No one gets off. It has to stop by their licence. It has to stop just in case there's somebody running around. Oh, my God. They've literally just got up to 20 miles an hour, and they're stopping again. Every now and then, someone gets on, someone gets off. Why can't they just have a little more fucking energy about them and walk further?
And that, people, is what grinds my gears.
See, they stop so that they don't run over their
it's
timetable.
It's called regulating servers.
It's shit.
It's a load of rubbish. In London, which where I live, and I use public transport, you get on a bus, and you're quite right, it goes about 20 metres down the road, stops either for traffic, kids in the street, or the fact that they've got another stop to stop at, and they open the doors, no one gets off, no one gets on, and it's a blooming waste of my time.
Yep. I'll agree with that.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
What was the other topic?
Well, there was obviously a bit about freedom. They said, and freedom of speech, which I assume is either speech or spinach.
Yes, this is my typo. My typo, apologies.
Freedom of spinach, Popeye's favourite topic. Plus the return of Tommy Boy, never heard of him.
No. Was that it?
That was it, yeah.
I'm sure there was some
a
more.
Bit lightweight on the topics this week. Matt obviously, you know, wasn't reading the BBC News website long enough this
don't
week.
Don't you start again. you don't know. Not only have I been seriously ill this week, I've been seriously busy as well. I know. Don't get that violin out, Stu. The weight of your chin will break.
See if I can find a topic for you, Matt. Hold on.
Would you like find a topic for me, G-Man? Because I've not been very well this week.
I've been very, very ill this week.
I've been ill, and I've just had everyone's been out of the office, and I've been on my own, and I've had all this stuff to do for work, and everyone's been relying on me to make it happen. I just haven't felt up to the task.
Oh, I didn't.
I had a Red Bull, and it made me feel paranoid. What? I didn't know what to do.
Sounds like you need a hug.
Not from
off
you.
Me,
no.
Let's face it, Gary. If you got anywhere near you and me, it'd be a bit of a hard job to have a hug anyway, wouldn't it? So.
Well, that's brilliant, G-Man. Thank you for the topics there. So we've got, what,
that's
freedom
cheers,
of speech, what grinds your gears about buses and stuff like that. Well, generally, anybody's gears grinding by
hello.
Anything.
Yeah. Hello, on the phone?
Yeah, well, hello.
Hello?
Hello?
It's me.
Hello, right? Chris.
Don't hang up a minute, because I was going to do all kinds of crazy, crazy stuff.
Go on,
that even John Peel would have been proud of. He was produced very, very well by some... I was going to do loads of stuff. A bit of Spike Milligan. I was going to have a go at you. Stu.
Thanks, mate.
Yeah.
Dirty
Mac.
Scumbag Brummy.
Let's hear it, then.
Scumbag fuck pig, never come jump, chop down, never come on. Anyway, we're all asleep now, but we did want to mention, even though we had, you know... Is everybody there? Are you going to cop me up?
We're listening to you.
Oh, my God, you start saying something, and then we're all listening, and then you go, is anyone there?
Damn, Matt. You're up, mate.
I said, you start talking about something, Chris, so we all shut up and listen, right, and give you a bit of respect, and then after 5 minutes you turn around and go, hang on a minute, is anybody there? And then you start again, so we never actually reach a point.
Well, because I was brought up this way, the bus, I thought he was going to be in tonight.
Well, he was, and you talked to him, you told him to fuck off, and he went.
I knew it was going to happen, he was going to have a fake machine.
Weren't you watching the webcams?
I was brought up by the bus, and he says, get on with it. Get on with it. You can't hang about talking. Nobody cares about your day. Nobody cares about your life, how you see the world. And I'm singing, all my heart's pounded. I don't know how long I've got to go. An old shoo-in mess, even though we don't know in that an old G.O. Joe, I feel like it. Family, I do, you know that way.
Yeah, we know exactly what you mean. Hey, I've got a topic.
Sorry, bud.
I've got a topic, Chris, which I was reading in the paper earlier right? Man U and Chelsea, right? The Champions League final. Just get rid of him. I've got a point being missed in the debate, and I'll actually make it for a change. Right, Man U and Chelsea, Champions League final. Man U won, all right? Is it fair, considering that they're £1.5 billion in debt? They get themselves into debt to buy the biggest stars in the world in order to win these matches. Is it fair on the Spanish and Italian teams who are in credit, who are not so much in debt, maybe a little bit, but should they be allowed to win it?
Show me a football team in this country that isn't in debt.
Leicester City?
Well, I would put forward...
We're in shit, we're not in debt.
I'd put forward a question, why can't they do it?
Why
but
not?
Should it be allowed for people to borrow billions and billions because they've got a global brand and they can borrow that money to win championships?
That's what business is all about, isn't it? Loans and everything else like that.
Let's not confuse business with sport.
Can you?
It is very much a business at the moment.
Is it fair that Matt Hollick, with his job at a radio station, could get a mortgage to buy a house which he can't afford to buy cash outright? Same deal, isn't it?
Yes.
You get lent money by a bank to do something?
The more money you have, the more money they will lend you.
Exactly.
As long as the money lenders get the money back, it doesn't really matter.
If you're profitable,
I think it's allowed. They're allowed to do it. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Because there's nothing to stop the Spanish and Italian teams doing exactly the same.
No.
Nothing to stop.
Well, no,
there
is, because it's actually been made illegal by FIFA. They're not allowed to borrow. They're not allowed to be in debt. And
but if it was FIFA, England, then surely that applies to us as well.
No. It's a European thing. England are not.
Last I looked, we were still in Europe.
Yeah, no, I can't give you. Don't be an arse.
You see that hole? I'm just going to keep picking at it.
Yeah, it's going to get bigger and bigger.
Stuart, My darling, please don't be an arse. Your Uncle Matt is trying to make a very valid point. No, I believe, all right, now it is ready for somebody to call in and prove me wrong when they found it on the internet, but I believe that we're the only country in football that allows our teams to be in debt. It's actually against rules for other countries to be in debt, football-wise.
Well, that's naughty then, isn't it?
Yeah. On the phone, hello?
Can I give my weight for the weight loss challenge, please, Chewin?
Yes, very quickly, go on.
It's disaster this week.
Yeah.
It's a disaster 18-7. Every week with you.
18-7. Alan, that means you put nearly a fucking stone on, pardon my French, a stone on? A stone on in a week.
Are you sure you've set it correctly?
Well, unfortunately, we've had the family come over today and we've had a barbecue. Wow.
Well, you've been eating lard.
Another really interesting point from Alan. Thank you very much, Alan. We'll see you in about 10 minutes. Yeah, brilliant.
They've had a barbecue. Hello? Hello?
If you had a barbecue, you'd probably spat over everybody's fucking hot dog. Important things to say, but a lot of things. I don't want to talk about football because it's not my code.
Right.
Is that all right?
That's fine.
Yep.
You talk about what you like to talk about, Chris.
What would you like to talk about?
I'm here, Chris. Yeah, I'm in the studio.
Hello, bud. How you doing?
I'm all right. How are you, sir?
How'd the move go?
Sodden? What?
How did the move go?
Oh, yeah, it went all well. We're all in there, yeah.
Settled, didn't it? Did you get any of your spiritual pals to move anything by, what you call...
telekinesis.
That's all I'd have done if I could contact the dead. I'd get them to do things for me, you know that way?
I know what you mean. No, not at anything...
Yeah, you can.
I know.
Get them to post a letter or something. You know that way? They've got fuck all to do, haven't they? You know that way? It's nice to be in touch with the dead. I'll cut you off then.
No.
I thought I did. I was kneeling anyway. I don't want to talk about the football. And
right.
Matthew cut me off. It's not my kind of thing. I have other things to talk about, more important things to tell me. Please don't cut me off this time. I will promise you, sir, I'll make my
point. What would you like?
Just get to the bloody point! You say you've got things to talk about and you don't talk about them. You waffle on about saying you've got things to talk about. Just move it on!
Who's this? I don't think
that
this flatters the listeners.
I think I've burst the blood vessel then.
Stuff like that.
What are your topics, Chris?
Play my coin purse and all stuff like that.
Chris, before we go any further...
I'm going for the MI5, but I don't. Here, are you talking about free speech? How are you?
Chris, I've got one question, right? And I know everybody who's listening right now, this will be on the tip of their tongue.
Right.
Have you buffered?
No, of course I'm fucking buffered. And even if I hadn't, Aaron, the right Reverend Aaron, you know what I would do? You know what I would say? But you know, if you were thinking along those lines, if you don't mind me saying so,
yeah.
And it's a perfectly reasonable question, but what I would say, in there, have you cut me off?
What? Yes, come on.
Well, if you don't get to the point.
Does anybody know how you block a phone number?
Yes.
How do you block a phone number? Do you have to ring up BT or something and say, I need this number blocking, this guy chats bollocks, and it just takes up way too much airtime?
My best pal is, Jesus. But he don't know me yet.
They say they're listening. I've kind of switched off.
Fucking lies and fucking rules then. Right, if I was Alan Caddick, stare at a wall until my arms, like the Badarama, I would stare at the wall until my arms and legs fell off. But I am not Alan Caddick. So I will answer your question, Aaron. Are you there?
Yes, mate.
Right then, hang on, I was thinking about what you were talking about, and I just fucking forgot what we were going to say. Shit, it. Hang on, no, I was there, I was going to say it. I will speak from the middle of my... And then you cut me off. G-man! Anyway, no, man, you! You there? Ah, oh, fuck him.
The James Whale Radio Show, you're live on the air. Hi, how are you? Hello?
Hello, James. Who's... Radio UK. Tuesday, on the internet. Call James Whale. Show on Play Radio UK. James Whale.
Very good. Yeah, we'll clip it and we'll play it, and that's it.
The James Whale Radio Show, Tuesday, 6 till 10 p.m. UK time, only on PlayTwoUK. It's not the Tommy Boyd Show with Matt and Stu, only on PlayTwoUK. Beware, the content of this show may offend.
Have we spoken to Isolde, as I understood?
We haven't spoken properly. To Isolde at
Isolde,
all.
Isolde, Isolde. Isolde,
with an A on the end.
Isolde. Oh, yeah. I thought it was an E on the end.
No.
You can. Oh, you can. Be, for a price, you'll be what you want it to be. I don't know that. I've only just met Isolde. I do not know what she does for money in her private life. How are you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Nice songs.
Thank you.
How long have you been playing?
That's a euphemism, by the way. Nice songs.
Oh, right.
No, it's not.
No, if I'm going to be dirty, I'd have said nice tits.
We can actually pretty much back that up. I'll agree.
Easy.
Well, Isolde's playing some music for us tonight on the Isolde is playing some music tonight for us on the show, which is very kind of you to come down and do so.
Oh, thank you for having me.
It's an absolute pleasure. And we had Joe last week, and you guys had a nice muso chat before we went on air, didn't we?
We've had the musicians
chat. There was literally smoke coming from the corner. You were chatting that fast, and me and Stu just looked at each other. Well, we'll leave then, too.
Yes. We know what we are talking about.
Of course, yes.
Uh-huh. And unsigned at the minute, obviously.
Yes, yes.
Do you want to be a famous rock? Do you want to be a rock star like Nickelback says, you know?
Yeah, that would be nice.
Yeah.
But obviously I'm not, so the main enjoyment is just doing the music.
Yeah. So what, are we having three tracks tonight? We started with one.
We've had another. We've had another, and then there'll be another one up in about an hour and a bit.
Yes, okay. That's brilliant, and I'm very, very impressed. So Isolde, welcome to the show.
Hello, thank you.
01243-5560 is on the number if you want to, you could even get Isolde to sing a cappella without the keyboard in the other room.
A cappella. Or me and Aaron. Aaron can do the beatbox, and Al did the scratching, like.
Wicked and wild.
Yeah. Like that. Yeah. And you can rap over the top of it.
That's a bit like the Eurovision Spanish entrance.
Oh, was it?
Yes.
Oh, really?
It was like seven very, very attractive young ladies dancing around, and a very strange man with an Elvis quiff looking a bit pervy. To be honest,
that was really odd, wasn't
going
it?
cheeky like that. They scored more than us.
Cheeky.
Cheeky.
That's a rip off, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a bit.
I think it is, isn't it? On the phone, hello.
Hi, Sir Richard here.
Richard, how are you?
All right, thanks.
Good, mate. What can I do for you, mate?
Well, I phoned you on a related subject about a couple of months ago.
Mm-hmm.
I was, you probably don't remember, but I was asking you about the sort of what happens after. You know, you've been out with someone for a while, and then, you know, the initial feeling changed and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Well, I kept debating whether that was happened to me or not. I split up with my girlfriend a couple of weeks ago.
Right.
For 13 years.
Right.
So I've sort of come on the market, as you might say.
Uh-huh.
So the question is, I've debated this with various other radio fans, you could say,
mm-hmm.
Spoke to Nick Abbott about it for about 10 seconds before he cut me off. but how important is it to have common interests with your partner?
Ladies?
What do you think?
Well, it depends. If you have common interests, then you're always going to have something to talk about, but then you could run out of something.
Yeah, it gets boring. Yeah. It's better to have opposing views and a bit of fire.
Yes.
Normally the differences in your partner are the things that attracted you in the first place. So when they become things you fight about later, you've got to try and remember that that's what you were attracted to in the first place. So yeah, think a bit of both, really. Otherwise, you could just kill them. Most of my ex-boyfriends are buried under my patio.
I think the wife and I don't have...
We are going to have the police in here one day on a kind of Harold Shipman uncover protest show.
I've in the past week said that I would kill all criminals. I've now just told everyone I've killed all my ex-boyfriends. I haven't actually, I just wrote songs about them and humiliated them publicly.
If there are any of Joe's ex-boyfriends listening, let us know. How are you? Are you alive or are you dead? Of course you're great.
Oh no, don't.
Aaron's pointing meaningfully. What's up, Aaron?
Haven't you been doing some work in your loft?
I've been doing quite a bit of work in my loft.
There's nothing under the floorboards up there now, is there?
No, that's not a euphemism, is it?
It might be in the eaves.
So before we get sidetracked very quickly there, Richard, does that answer your question?
Kind of. I mean, I was wondering, because I'm thinking of doing online dating.
Yeah.
and I'm wondering whether I should mention that I'm into talk radio or not.
I would put something along the lines of you enjoy conversation.
Yeah, no, you enjoy conversation on a different level to what most people have. You enjoy it when it's something, a topic is investigated further than what most people might feel comfortable doing. So you kind of like to extend the boundaries of what everybody sort of takes as the norm.
That would be a long advert.
It would be a long advert.
But I don't think there's anything wrong with advertising.
Was that Matt?
Yeah, it was Matt. Yeah.
Oh, that's quite genius, though.
Ooh. Well, I've heard it said. The other thing is, Richard, right, and I have it on good authority, that if you're actually after a lady, then there are a couple of things that you have to be able to do in order to become slightly more attractive. Now, I'll find out if these are wrong or not, because these are facts, right?
Okay.
If you do your own washing and you can clean your own house.
Oh, oh, that'd be a dream. Anyway.
There you go, you see? Number one, in the bag.
No, it's not if you can, it's if you do.
Yeah, if you do, yeah. Right, and the other thing is, always have 40 or 50 quid in your wallet, because if you meet that special somebody, and it just so happens to be a spontaneous sort of drink or anything like that, and you haven't got cash, you look very silly. So you always need to have enough cash to buy drink and flowers in your wallet.
Yeah, actually, that's not bad.
Very good. If it's any help, okay. Richard, I have a friend, I have a couple of friends who've done internet dating, and have ended up going on to get married to the person they met, so...
I did internet dating a couple of years ago, and I technically went out with a guy for about 6 to 8 months.
Same here.
I never actually met him.
Oh, we met.
But I just thought he was a bee's knees. He was great till he needed to shag someone who was real. a bit unfortunate, but, you know, 8 months.
I met someone on the internet. It wasn't a dating site. It was like a forum, stupid flirty forum site we were doing for work, and I was with her for about 6 or 7 months before we split.
Facebook.
I mean, it wasn't Facebook. It was... Flirtomatic. It was something we did at a station in Oxford. Some promotion. Yeah. Flirtomatic.com. You send people like kisses and hugs and slaps and stuff like that.
I know
that.
We could sign up a few people at work to that, Isolde, couldn't we? Flirtomatic.
Could we?
Mm. Do you think we should sign up? Because there's one particular person.
Still uncovering something.
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
There's one particular person we have in mind that I have in mind that we could possibly. He enjoys a bit of photography.
Don't hate me, Stu.
Can I see these photos of Isolde that this man's been taking while she's naked?
They're not of Isolde. Richard, thanks for your call. Hope that helps, mate.
Yeah, that's great. Thanks.
Cheers, mate. Take care. Ta-da.
See ya.
That was brilliant. I like that.
On the phone,
hello. Again.
Good evening, Joe. Are you
going to
do another
tune
for us like you did last week?
No, she's not. Alan? Alan?
I can play the piano.
Alan, right, I will give you an imaginary £100 if the next call you make actually makes a valid point of something we might actually be talking about tonight and actually seems to be kind of in... this is where you hang up and find a valid point. Thank you. He needs to be careful around that man, doesn't
it's
he?
Good, isn't it? 01243 55 60 60. If you want to talk about, I'll talk about that. Do that in a minute. Calm down, chill out.
No, suggestion, not demand. Suggestion, not demand. Do this, question mark, dot, dot, dot.
Freedom of speech.
Twat.
Should Matt be given the right to freedom of speech?
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Does he overstep the boundary sometimes?
Oh, come on, am I not here to overstep boundaries? Yeah. Jesus.
Mohammed Al-Fayed.
You brought this one up, and I'm kind of like, well, Scotland is never going to become independent anyway.
The thing is, right, my point on
this... Nobody turns up enough for the vote.
My view on Mohammed Al-Fayed, right, is that he's not happy where he is now, right? Mm. So he's just stopped sponging off us, given the fact that he's not paying the full-on taxes he should be paying because he's a...
Yeah, but he's hardly sponging.
Well, he is. He's taking your money at Harrods, he's not paying the taxes on it.
Yes,
because
but you
he's
are getting goods in return.
Right, but not something that you and I could probably afford.
Oh, I go there all the time, don't you?
Oh, darling, no.
Can I just say, I never really knew what to make of Fayed until I saw him on the Ali G show a few years ago.
Now, that was actually the best thing he's ever done.
Well, no, but didn't it just make him out to look like a wanker?
Yes.
Because Ali G played the hot stepper, and Ali G went, "Here come the hot stepper," put the mic into Al-Fayed, and Al-Fayed went, "Al-Fayed," and Ali G went, "The lyrical gangster, Al-Fayed." Yeah. "Excuse me, Mr. Officer," and all he could say was, "Al-Fayed, stop living like that, Al-Fayed." But no, it wasn't. Because you could see it in his eyes, he was thinking, what do I say next? You can actually see the mental strain in his face. What do I say next? Al-Fayed.
Actually, most people meeting Ali G shoves a microphone in your face. What are you going to say? I think I'd probably say Al-Fayed as well.
Break his nose and say, "Take that microphone out of my face, you fake Jewish weirdo."
On the phone, hello?
Freedom of speech.
I don't think Matt can have freedom of speech because he's not letting me have freedom of speech.
Thanks,
oh,
Alan.
Okay, brilliant.
I think freedom of speech should be regulated in that if you have anything important
Whoa,
to say, it's
don't
okay.
mention the regulation word. Don't mention the regulation word. We don't have them.
Fall out and I'll show you my knickers if I'm no good at singing.
Really?
Oh, right.
Hello on the phone.
Who the fuck are you?
Hello on the phone.
Hello, on the phone.
Good evening.
I'd like to complain.
Would you? What would you like to complain about?
You.
Good evening. This is the Play Radio Complaints Line.
Yes, your call is held in a queue and will be answered shortly. You are number 34 in the queue. Yeah. We value you as a customer and appreciate
your call.
Your call
is being held in a queue.
Jesus, this is this bunch of cunts. I'm in a queue now.
Please continue to hold. Your call is in a queue.
I don't know what they're doing, but they're not very inventive, these fucking idiots. Your call is very important to us. Please continue to hold. You
are now number 32 in the queue.
You are in queue position 29. Please continue to hold.
Here at the Not the Tommy Boyd Show, we appreciate your call. It's important to us that you don't go anywhere, and the complaints department will see to you shortly.
Hello on the phone.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Yeah.
Hi, bud. All right.
Yeah, not bad. Are you? I'm sorry, you've come through to the wrong department, mate. You need the complaints department on 2150. Let me just transfer you to 2150. Okay, transferring you now.
Thanks very much. Yeah, I can have a wank in Russian name. Soon as we're on, I'll start.
Please continue to hold. Your call is important to us.
You are queue position 24.
Fucking, you're talking to machines there, yeah, I am. Anyway, sooner they hear the beep, I'll be on, and then we'll give them a fucking what, bro. That's a fact.
Good evening, British Gas.
It must be racing, son. I'd like to request, hello?
British Gas, hello?
Hello, I'd like to request, what you call a request, please.
Is that to get a gas line? Gas?
Duncan Barks to sing his rubbish tune.
Is that for a gas fire, sir? I guess not.
some people, honestly, you answer a call, all polite, you ask them what they want, and they just swear at you and go.
Charming, isn't it?
01243-55-6060, who's this?
Oh, hello, my name is Duncan.
Duncan?
I used to go out with Joe, one of our ex-boyfriends. I just wanted to tell you, I've been in hospital for some time.
Oh.
What was the method? Was it poison, Duncan?
Well, I've got a list here. There was an ACL injury, an Achilles tendonitis, altitude illness, anorexia, athlete's foot, back pain, blisters, bulimia, bursitis.
But enough about me.
Casting, carpal tunnel syndrome, condylarthritis, concussion, cramping muscles, a cycling injury, exercise extreme heat.
How did you manage to get a cycling injury with cramping muscles and carpal tunnel syndrome?
Let me tell you, she can do anything, that woman. Growth plane injuries, hamstring pull, a heel spur, a herniated disc, a hip pointer, a hip replacement, obviously. then there was some knee chlamydrasia, Pickler syndrome. Obviously there was lupus, that was a serious one. Muscle sprains, cramps, meniscitis injuries, neck injuries, noisy joints that kept her up at night, osteoporosis, ovary syndromes, Pickler syndrome, pronation, quadriceps, running, rowing, sciatic.
Is this guy just reading the NHS dictionary?
Well, let me tell you, Mr. Hollick, don't go near that woman. She will kill you.
Brilliant. Thank you very much for your call. If you're an ex-boyfriend of Joe, 01243-55-6060.
On this line, hello? That sounds a bit like the announcements at Waterloo Station. You can't understand them.
Who could that mystery man have been?
I don't know. Who could that caller have been?
What, Duncan?
No, the one after it.
Oh, the one after it. Oh, yeah.
Who was the caller?
Mystery caller, yeah.
Mystery caller.
Mystery
caller. Do you know, I just went blank there for a second.
Who was trying to do your movie trailer voice? Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, coming up this week.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Hey, alright. Well, anybody who wants to come in and fucking fight me, alright? We're going to tie him to the train. Gouge your fucking eyes out, a bastard.
fucker.
Well, that's lovely. Of course,
I didn't quite kill him, unfortunately. No, no. I wish I had.
It sounds like he gave you a run for his for your money.
Yeah.
But here at Another Tommy Boyd Show, we do not condone such actions.
Of course not.
Unless Joe's beating someone, and
of
then
course. No one's arguing with Joe.
And then as long as we can film it, we'll be all right.
Yeah. In fact, do you think we could Do you think we could manifest a small mud pit for Isolde and Joe to have a fight in? Before,
no, because we just talk about music and stuff. And
they would.
They'd just
be,
stage
they'd just well, be sat there going, the mud's drying, it'll come off now.
It but doesn't.
How was your keyboard playing?
It doesn't necessarily have to be a fight, just a friendly grapple.
Fondle. Yeah.
Right. Well, sorry, sure soft the mud. If I get you 20 quid each, we have lesbian sex?
20, no.
20 quid?
Well, they get pleasure out of it as well as a few drinks. What?
I
gave you both a can of Foster's.
Right, we'll do it. Fine.
Brilliant. Right, studio at playradiouk.com. We will read out all your emails. If you are a Skyper, play.radio.uk. 01243 55 60 60 on the phones, and of course 0208 123 1088. And if you know what you're doing, you're there already. If you don't, it's not a problem. Go to nttbs.com and you can see our ugly mugs.
Well, you're ugly, mate. Speak for yourself.
Oh, come off it,
I'm feeling quite, you know.
You look good, mate. You look good. Right. Are we doing it right? Duncan Barkus, Barmy Barkus, started the show with Tommy Boyd way back in August. He now works for a talk radio station in Liverpool and is doing his amazing, normal Duncan Barkus thing, which is very, very good. And he's put together a song about MPs.
Can I ask, if anybody has the Riley Martin Duncan Barkus clipped out?
It's just, in our folder.
Is it? Well, yeah. I need to get hold of that.
Okay, well...
But we'll play this.
Yeah, let's have this video. This is great. NTTBS.com, it's fantastic.
I'm through with paying for stuff I'd rather get for free. I'm at the bottom of my balance in financial misery. This life hasn't turned out quite the way I want it to be.
Order! Order!
I want a second house on the taxpayer's bill, and a fridge that someone else has to fill, and a king-size bed big enough for my researcher and me.
Does she do dictation as well?
I'll need a shopping list that's got no limit, and an armored Jag with a chauffeur in it. But I'll need a bigger van when I go to John Lewis's.
How much do we have to spend again?
I'm gonna trade this life for power and fame, for those two magic letters after my name. Cause we all just wanna be rich MPs, getting all life's little free luxuries. The perks come easy and the booze is cheap, and no one snitches cause we're all in deep. And we'll hang out in the party bar, in our Gucci loafers, smoking fat cigars. Every good taxpayer's gonna wind up broke. Our expense system is a national joke. Hey, 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 I wanna be an MP.
Order!
I wanna be great like Churchill without the sweat. Make promises that I seem to forget. Pass a couple of early motions so I can get an early dart.
I'll see you at the bar.
I want a cushy job for my kids and wife. I want a lunch account and an easy life. And a seat on the back bench where I can get a snooze in peace.
The benches are a bit hard, you know.
I'm gonna trade this life for power and fame. I'll go blue or red, I've really got no shame. Cause we all just wanna be rich MPs, getting all life's little free luxuries. The perks come easy and the booze is cheap, and no one snitches cause we're all in deep. And we'll hang out in the party bar, in our Gucci loafers, smoking fat cigars. Every good taxpayer's gonna wind up broke. Our expense system is a national joke. Hey, 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 I wanna be an MP.
And that was that, Duncan Barkus.
That's really good. And
I like that.
It kind of highlights the point that we've made a couple of times on the show, and I've ranted about this whole blooming expenses thing.
You realise you're going to have to ban Duncan Barkus from the show now, though.
Oh, did he mention his own station?
No, at the end, he's got the station thing there.
You're banned!
You're going to have to ban me from the show because I had the camera on it.
Well, let's talk about the banning while we play them.
Oh, all right.
If your satellite TV breaks down, you could be without all your favourite TV programmes and facing a big bill to pay. Just to get it back again, from only 12 pence a day, you can protect yourself and get the peace of mind you need from a service agreement with Satellite Direct, the UK's largest independent provider of service agreements for Sky TV systems. With our national network of highly trained engineers, we'll fix either your system or replace it quickly and at no extra cost. Call now for instant service. 0871 664 1400 or log on to www.satellitedirectuk.com for details. Satellite Direct UK. Your choice, our commitment.
Now, more great deals from 14travel.co.uk.
All this month, 14travel are offering two great deals for your holiday to Turkey. Go cheap and cheerful in our three-star bed and breakfast from just £169 per person. Or push the boat out with our luxurious five-star all-inclusive hotels from just £329 per person. All prices are based on an adult seven-night stay and include flights, transfers and accommodation. Terms and conditions apply.
For more information, call 14travel now on 0871 664 1405 or visit the website at www.14travel.co.uk.
For perfect personalised cards for any occasion delivered through the letterbox, go to playradiouk.com/moonpig.
This is not the Tommy Boyd Show with Stu and Matt on Play2UK. Beware, the content of this show may offend.
Hello?
Good evening.
No, never mind. Is that you, Stu?
Yes, mate.
Right then. Can I tell you what, would you pay me enough respect?
I am paying.
Because I never ever ring up with a silly voice and try to make stupid, ignorant remarks.
No.
And then all I ever do off you and Matt is you play things over the top of me to try and make me look like a fool.
Don't make you look like a fool. That's not the intention at all, Chris.
I wouldn't want to make you look like a fool, Chris.
Right then, well, that's what I thought to begin with, Matt. If you don't mind me saying so, Stu.
Well, we do apologise for that,
yeah.
Chris.
You ain't going to apologise, but I know you have your sneaky ways with your pals and you... Hang on, I nearly dropped the phone there. What did you want to ask about? Anyway. Hello?
Good evening.
Right, can you knock that fucking heartbreak music up? This is an important point.
Go on, then.
Right. Now, our mate, Victor Hugo Lolio.
Yeah.
Right. But can you tell me? Right, he speaks Russian, doesn't he? He knows about Russian things. I know he's not an engineer.
Yes. He does know Russian, yeah,
right.
And Polish.
Well, yeah. Are we on? Because, you know, I do seem like I'm half a fucking idiot.
No, Chris, we don't think about that.
Well, I have no point to make.
No.
You know, what are you talking about, Chris? And Matt's no better. And you want to talk about the football? It's not my code.
I didn't mention
you know
the football.
That, right? Well, you do.
I do sometimes, but,
fan,
yeah, you know.
I'm the football fan, Chris, my friend.
Well, you've got nothing better to do than hang around the radio station, and I'd hang around with you if I had anything to do. Hang on, no, I'm going to do it! All right, I'm going to ask! Anyway, go on, you're right. I've just shouted at my friend there.
That's all right.
Anyway.
Ask.
Right.
Go ahead.
Here, Russian, right?
Yeah.
So, Sykes, the Karma River, you ever heard about that? The biggest fucking shot gear company in the world, and it fucking burned down. Never heard of it?
No.
The point was, it was never reported, and G-Man could report it. When was it? About 15 years ago. Anyway, he doesn't do a lot of that. Are you there?
Yeah.
All right, then. Well, this is fucking... This is what you call a bombshell.
I know, but
isn't it? You're trying to just hang around and flop around and get yourself a bit of work in this kind of industry. But this is what we need reporting. Now we got the fucking... Well, the boss never turned up, did he?
Yeah, he did.
Ain't turned up.
You talked to him, Chris.
To you don't even fucking like me, you bitch.
Oh, right, fine. Fine. If you want to be like that, Chris, we can be like that, mate. If you want to sit there and say you don't even fucking like me, moan, bloody, bloody, bloody. Hello, I'm a little kid and I'm not getting my airtime, boo fucking who. Right, if you want to sit there and do that, mate, we can do that. Unfortunately for you, we've got a button here that says drop. All right? Now make your point and move on. Gee, isn't George Galloway doing a show you can call into or something?
I'm not going to have an argument with me, mate. I've told you, I put all my attention in the pit of my stomach and from the pocket. I'm speaking from the emptiness in the middle of, you know, the the middle of my brain.
Yeah.
Yeah, but no, I really am, because I thought the bus was coming, and I thought, well, that'll be all right.
Are we going round in circles, anyone? Yeah, we're going round in circles. Do you want to cut this circle off and make it a straight line? Thank you.
Well, okay. Tommy!
It was never mentioned. It was the biggest fucking Jewish fire in the world. It was a truck gear company on the Karma River, about 1917.
Unfortunately, you're not.
I know you can put me through, Victor Huguenot and all that. Anyway, the geyser was Staines, Mick Ferrari, and it was bang on, but it never got in the news.
Well, you go and research it and give us a shout back when you tell us all about it.
No, why should I do that? You do the research.
All right, this is how you want to be, Stu.
Right, I'm going to go and do it now, right?
Okay, yeah.
Just doing a bit of research, okay? On behalf of Chris. This music isn't very conducive for research. Let's just go that one. Let's do that one.
See that? Click on that website. That's it. Now go there.
Right.
There you go. You see that?
Yeah.
It says Chris is a wanker.
No, it doesn't say that. No, that's what it says in Russian.
Oh, right. That's in Russian.
Yeah.
Right. So where's Big Jewish Fire?
Yeah. Is that what he said? I thought he said Top Gear. I thought the Top Gear studio had burned down.
But click on that link there.
Yeah.
Watch that video.
Right.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
There's a picture of Leslie.
What's Leslie doing in a Jewish fire?
I don't know.
Must be the hairspray.
Scary, isn't it?
Yeah.
On the phone, hello?
I don't know what to do. I need some advice.
Alan, go ahead.
I'm fed up with my single life.
You're fed up with his single life?
I want a Zara date like you tried to do with Zara.
I know, and Zara blew everybody out.
And off.
And no.
You should, yeah, the one about, it's allegedly, I'm not going to accuse Zara of anything, but I've heard a few rumours. I'm only joking.
She's got excellent hair.
All right, well, here's a tip, Alan. Fucking stop being a sex pest!
I tried that and it didn't work.
You know what you need? Do you know what you need, Alan?
So I see. So going back to being a sex pest might actually make it work.
Do you know what Alan needs? He needs a warm, dead body.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Sure, a joke can help him out.
He is being intensive, isn't he?
He's bit.
So, if there's any advice you can offer.
Me?
Yeah. You know, whatever Alan
not
calls
really.
Up for always ends up in Joe.
Yeah.
Is there anything you would like to say? Joe?
I
can I see you naked? Joe, you look amazing tonight. And who's the third girl in the studio?
The third girl?
Second.
Well, he's only counting himself.
Yeah. All right, fair enough. Alan, I think your problem lies with your slightly strange way of approaching and talking to women. I think what you need to do is go away and read the 10 Rules to Casanova by I'm Shit at Pulling, and then try again.
Well, can you pass it on to Reverend Riedel? Maybe he got some advice.
Reverend Riedel. Weedle, even.
Yeah.
Hello, Alan. You all right, sir?
I'd like you to just turn that way. I don't know what you're thinking.
I need some advice and guidance.
All right, the only advice I've got for Pulling, Alan, is make them laugh. Apparently, ladies like a man that can make them laugh.
So yeah, laughing with you.
Yeah, laughing with you, not at you.
Yeah.
So if you can...
You've pulled, Aaron, look!
If you can, there you go, see? So if you can make a girl laugh, then, you know...
It helps if you can make her cum.
You know what Matt said about me being a sex pest?
Yeah.
You man just said on a Skype chat, hold on, man, doesn't Holic go all over as a female guest?
He does, doesn't he?
Actually, no, I don't.
He doesn't do it as blatantly, does he?
He's only mentioned about the fact that... It's only mentioned about twice now, some...
Yeah.
And Chopper's calling me a homo.
You know why he's doing it, though, Alan?
There's banter and there's harassment. There's two different things.
Matt's only doing it because he's trying to hide the rumours that James Whale started that he was gay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, now, while we're on that subject... Yeah, old Matt, the gay boy...
So that's why he's doing it.
Thank you for your call, Alan.
Matt is gay producer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Does that mean I produce gay people?
Excellent.
Thank you.
I mean, in your dreams, yes. On the phone, hello.
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 It's me again.
Yeah, I know, and I'm sick of it already, Chris.
Wait, he's talking normally.
Yeah.
This should have got no fucking point. That's missing. I want to talk to the healer, all right?
You talk to the
fucking maniac.
The healer Weedle.
You're a capitalist, dogs, Jekylls. I want to talk to old Rare and Ellen.
You know what? I want you to make a fucking point.
Sorry, bud.
No bud tonight, Chris, mate. You're starting to piss me right off.
All right, what does that mean? So I'm just ringing up because...
What you're doing is, every time you hang up, you're ringing back up with the same old shit. Yeah, same old bollocks again, exactly.
I'm ringing in for the Aaron, the right rare in Aaron.
Hello.
You know, what you're doing is you're ringing in to talk to somebody else who's not going to cut you off. And to be honest...
I don't care if Oh, come on, give me a break, man.
I will give you a break if ever I see you in real bloody life, mate. I'll break your fucking nose, that's what I'll do, mate. Honestly. God, Jesus.
What you got is a fucking lack of communication.
Right,
failure to communicate.
Someone else call in, because if that light starts going green, it means we've got a reason to get rid of him.
What are you going to do? Are you going to listen to some fucking idiot, the ones who got more about that?
Hang on a minute, that's you! That's you, Chris! You're the fucking idiot!
I need healing!
You need healing? Right, go to a fucking mental doctor! Go to a psychiatrist! Go and see your mum for a hug! No, just do something other than call us!
This is your decision! Now, hey, look, there's other people in the studio! You can cut off any time you like!
Young Christopher?
Chris.
It sounds like Alan Caddick now.
Chris.
Fucking give him a dig for me, will
Chris?
You? I'm not soft.
Chris?
Smack him in the face, Chris, and help me.
Chris?
Help me.
Chris?
Mama.
Go on.
Bye.
you pushed the wrong one, mate.
No, I haven't.
Right. Have you? You haven't? No.
I just cut someone off because he's having to cut the wrong
I'm
one.
I'm sorry, I didn't see the green thing. I should leave you to it, shouldn't I?
What the hell is going on?
Maybe you can tell us.
I ain't got a clue.
He's back for one night.
Yeah.
It's Jim and Junior. Has Chris got an obsession with me or something?
I think so.
He laughs, you.
I'm ringing up with a genuine topic now.
All right, please ring up with
please
me.
Please do, please. Before I have to reposition.
I listened this week to Scarlett Johansson's album.
You're not doing anything, Third
Yes.
Voice.
Scarlett Johansson's got an album out.
She's got, now, there you are. See, you didn't know it either.
No.
No, she's released a single, which is actually pretty good. You can find it on YouTube. And she's released an album. Now, isn't she already famous for one thing? Why the hell does she need to become... I mean, normally people who sing go into acting. I'm not suggesting either of the ladies are going to do that.
Oh, God, no, bad idea for me.
She's doing it the wrong way round. What is this trying to prove? What is this kind of, I'm an actress, so I'll have a go at singing
line? Well, it's like Robson and Jerome, isn't it?
What's wrong with that? Juliette Lewis has done it quite successfully.
Marty McCutcheon.
Not so
Australian chick. What's her name? Kylie?
Yeah, Kylie Danny. Yeah.
Holly Valance.
Jason Donovan.
Yeah.
Actually, no.
The other guy, was it Paul who owned Lassiter's?
Craig McLaughlin and Check 1-2.
Yeah.
Craig McLaughlin, Anton Deck. Anton Deck. Watch us wreck the mic.
And then he did.
Thank you. Brilliant. I point at the studio when they're about to say psych. And Aaron does it 3 seconds late, and everyone else just sits there and stares blankly at me. That's what you call teamwork, G-Man. That is what you call a team who has got your back, you know?
Yeah.
So do you think she's famous enough then, and she'd just sort of be happy with
her, the fame she's got?
She's
a very good actress.
Yes.
She's a very good actress. I'm not just oogling over a pretty lady. I think she's a very good actress.
This is her song in the background.
Why she feels the need to remove herself from the acting world and try singing.
Well, maybe she just likes singing. And in her position that she's got, she can do that, and she's got the money, why not?
I tell you what, G-Man, thanks
no
for
problem.
Thanks for bringing our attention to that.
J-Lo and Minnie Driver, they're the other two that did it as well.
Did they? Ooh.
Oh,
J-Lo's
Minnie Driver,
right.
Jesus, that was awful.
Minnie Driver stuff.
She was on, I think it was Jonathan Ross or something a couple of weeks ago. That was terrible, her song.
Yeah.
Who was that bird, that model, Cerise,
Paris Hilton?
Cerise, Celine,
sang a song.
Crimson, oh, fuck.
What's her name? Anyway, blonde bitch, rubbish, absolute crap. I think you should, if you can sing, no problem. That's but right. If you can't, just stop.
Thanks, brilliant. G-Man, take care.
Pleasure.
Bye, bye, bye. Who else we got? Hello.
This line, hello.
Greetings, Blofeld, it's Sean Connery.
Hello, Leslie.
License to weight loss.
I knew you'd get me, you always bloody
do. It's your stupid female girly speech impediment.
We can't all be Uncle Davey and do these great voices, you know.
Well,
but what I was going to say is, I know Aaron's problem. Not Aaron, Alan.
Thanks,
Can I just say, too many people have been doing that.
Do we have to make a show about talking about Alan's problems? I think it's fairly obvious what they are.
Can I just ask Leslie to hold on for 2 seconds? We have got a very important caller
very
on the phone.
Very important caller, very hello.
Stephen Hawking, good evening.
Good evening to Matt, Aaron, and Joe. I have nothing special to contribute tonight. A bit like Chris and Alan. Anyway, I'm wanting to know where I can listen and buy your guest's music. And is she single? If you could tell me, I would be most grateful. Oh well. Before I go, this is for Zelda. It's Brian Adams. By the way, Matt Bullock is a Muppet with a small penis.
You should know, stuck it in your wife's mouth a few times. Isolde, it's not the real Stephen Hawking, don't worry.
Thank you, Professor Hawking. Sorry about that, Leslie. We just had to take an important phone call, obviously. There,
so. Oh, Leslie! Another person who has dicks in their mouth. Hello.
So, what we'll do is we'll get some of Isolde's stuff up, if she allows us to, on our on the NTTBS.com website for download.
You're in control. Yeah? You do what you like. Yeah.
Is that okay?
You do what you like. And, fantastic, yeah.
So we'll do that during this week or next. NTTBS.com.
What we should have done is brought a camera, right? A video camera with a bit of time code on it and made your first music video while you were playing live.
Yeah.
We could have all been in the background.
Don't need to bring the sheep in.
No. You can leave the sheep at home. That's
actually,
all right.
Actually, can I just say, I watched your video again on, I think, on Thursday, Leslie. I've been doing a bit of listening back to old shows and sort of, you know, finding out what's going on, seeing how they sound and look and stuff. And I have to say that I was in tears of laughter. It was just as funny the second time.
The sheep bit is hilarious.
Well, it's the sheep bit and the parsnip, the meat and two veg, the parsnip bit, when you cut it off.
Fabulous.
I was just in absolute hysterics, Leslie. So, well done. You're not as thick as I thought you were.
Oh, well, thank you. Yeah. I had to do that at night, though, because a grown man getting caught with the sheep.
Are you right?
Yeah. How are your Velcro gloves?
It's not that. It's actually tweezer in the pubes.
Nice.
That stuff sticks.
Leslie, anything you want to say before I hang up on you?
Yeah, Alan.
Yeah.
He's been sending me sexy messages privately.
Has he?
So if he wants to take me up on it, I'll go on a date with him.
Right.
And he won't be single.
Okay. Right, we'll do that. Yep. We'll do that. You can hook up in the Skype chat, I'm sure.
Right, and we should.
No, he's blocked me.
Oh, no.
We should. Continue the rest of the weight loss challenge soon.
Yeah, we'll do it in the next half an hour or something like that. That'd be good.
Best of luck.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Cheers.
We need to pay some bills.
Yeah, well, let's do one more because this has been on hold for a while. Hello.
They're on hold for that long. They've gone.
They were.
Try the next one because they'll be on hold for ages otherwise.
Yeah. Hello.
I'm not taking that.
Okay, try the next one because they'll be on. Hello. Okay, let's have an ad break.
The following commercial will be heard by 3.3 million people and cost nothing. Derek Lee and Company offer friendly and professional advice and assistance to families and businesses in accounting, taxation and other financial and business matters. Whether it's financial advice you're after or help with your yearly tax return, Derek Lee and Company can look after your every need. For more information, call 01883 741997. Derek Lee and Company, the not-so-dull accountants.
If you want the chance to win valuable advertising, then enter your company into the Business Brainbuster. Just email your details to studio@playradiouk.com.
Ellington Lodge Hotel at the Concord Club, a unique place to stay. Going on a cruise or flight? Why not take advantage of the free short-term parking we offer to residents and extend your holiday by a night or two? Ellington Lodge is situated 2 minutes from Southampton Airport and Parkway Station, just off the M27 at Junction 5, and a short taxi ride from the Southampton Cruise Terminals. For more information, visit our website, theconcordclub.com.
Here at Play Radio, we understand that you can't hear all of our shows all of the time. That's why we give you the chance to listen again. Listen to your favourite bits streamed on your computer or download them to your MP3 player. It's your second chance to catch Not The Tommy Boyd Show with Stuart and Matt, The Business Brainbuster, interviews, sessions and much more. And it's as easy as ABC. A, go to playradiouk.com/podcast. B, click on the bits you've missed. And C, sit back and enjoy. Playradiouk.com, Planet Earth's local station. Live to the UK. News, information, entertainment, and the best music from the past 40 years. This is Play2UK. It's Not The Tommy Boyd Show with Matt and Stu, only on Play2UK. Beware, the content of this show may offend.
Don't you dare say the R word.
Just repositioning very
quickly. Oh, you said the R word!
On Aaron's behalf.
Bollocks to you all.
We don't reposition, we're already in a position.
Don't forget, Richard Hershey at 10 o'clock tonight with
Eddie Lodge! Eddie Lodge! Unfortunately,
if
can't
you think,
be in the studio.
If you think that I'm big, you wait till you see Eddie Lodge.
Yeah, he's got a massive cock.
It was Sid Little. So's Jeremy Beadle, but then on the other hand.
Got an email. We've got an email from Gary that says, actually, Matt, Real Madrid in 1999 owed $250 million after buying Zidane and Figo. They took out a £24.5 million loan to cover the loss of David Beckham 2 years ago, but they are still top of the Europe's rich list.
Yes. So they're not actually in debt.
Yeah.
Anymore.
Darcy
Man
says,
United are actually in debt. Man United are actually in debt. Go on.
And Darcy says, having just heard Matt do some human beatboxing, next time Alan calls, can you ask him to lay down some beats with his mouth? It goes on to say, I strongly suspect it'll make more sense than when he's trying to talk.
We've got another one. I think the only tip for Alan is to put an elastic band around it very tight. It'll drop off eventually.
I quite like the other suggestion from Darcy. It says, Alan should go knocking on the door of the house across the road from me, because from where I sat, the very attractive woman that lives there has so far undressed and dressed herself four times tonight. Unlike Chappers, she has no curtains.
0124355 6060. You can of course call 0208 123 1088. Studio play it ready. Oh no, no, no.
Matt.
No, mate, I'm sick of you, mate. I'm sick of you, mate. I've had enough.
I know, here, well listen.
Well then fucking say something worth saying. Instead of blocking up a perfectly decent phone line with perfectly decent callers.
You got Stu on. You're in the
chat.
Are you in charge tonight,
mate? Mate, me and Stu host the show with Aaron and Joe. All
right? Right.
So we're all in charge. We're all in charge, yeah.
So make it easy on me. You know what I mean?
I tell you what. Make it easy on me then. Make your point and fuck off.
I may seem a poor man at expressing myself, Matt. Are you there?
Yes.
Are you there, Joey?
Yes.
All right then.
Do you have a question about geology?
Well, we're all right. We can talk about anything. You know, hang on, I'd like to talk about you. You heard about that thing going off in Reno?
Yes, I have.
Have you?
Uh-huh.
What do you make of it as what you call a proper geologist?
Well, as a proper geologist, unfortunately, I can only say I don't know.
Well, it's a very... geologist, you say it's cool.
Nobody, nobody knows, really.
Do you not believe...
Well, it's probably...
We know what's going on.
If you let me listen... Right, it's probably because of.
You're not going to mention the fact that we can put a pulse into the middle of the earth and fucking make it.
No, you can't. The Pacific plate is moving away. I'm just going to keep talking from the North American plate, which causes the San Andreas Fault. It is only a few hundred or so miles from Reno. Therefore, earthquakes may or may not happen. Why they are increasing in frequency and magnitude, we do not know.
Indeed. Hello. There's a bit what? Like, there's like...
I'm crushing tucking. Your head! I'm crushing your head!
And Matt is crushing Aaron's
Does anyone remember
head.
The kids in the halls?
I remember that, yeah.
No. Hello, on the phone.
Hello.
Hello.
Davey here.
Hello, David, how are you, mate?
Very well, thanks.
Good,
very
good,
well.
Good, good. How's it going? All right over there?
Yes, very well. I hope that waiter sign isn't for me in the top camera there.
No. That was for the that was 30 seconds ago where Matt was trying to do a wanker towards Aaron because I turned the camera around.
I think I quite successfully did a wanker towards Aaron.
That'll be a bit for you to edit out.
And now I'm crushing his head. You see, I'm crushing his head.
Okay.
moving.
Yeah, I didn't find it funny either, Dave.
It's not meant to be funny. The Kids in the Halls wasn't particularly comedy. It was just weird.
What's happening, buddy?
Well, I was just wondering whether we were going to do any weight stuff tonight.
Well, Alan's done his, and we haven't done any of ours yet, but we will do before 10 o'clock. Yes, absolutely. Have you got yours handy?
Let's get it out of the way. Let's do it now. Let's do it.
Yeah, I've got 123.5, unfortunately, which means I'm, like, going nowhere. But I just wanted to say that this is the last week, isn't it?
No, next week is the weigh-in final, yes.
So we've only got a week. I've only got a week to do anything in this because I like them and nowhere.
Get the laxatives at the ready.
I have it on very good authority that we might have to have a judge's investigation.
Yes, I was going to say that we've been fed a feed. As you know, that's what happens when you get fed a feed.
My private eye.
Yeah, Jesus Christ, that's done enough damage to your wife already, hasn't it?
My private dick has been out doing some investigation and has come up with some of the results aren't quite exactly what.
Somebody could be cheating. I mean, it's like George Bush in the election.
I mean, imagine
Do you think that Randy was never a fat bastard in the first place?
Well, it could be.
Can't
that.
Mention any
it,
names.
It could be that Alan really hasn't been putting on all the weight that he says he's been putting on.
No, but he hasn't put any weight on at all. Legally,
G-Man, we can't allege it's who not it G-Man, might be.
It's Davey.
Sorry, Davey. Legally, we can't allege who it might be. The solicitors are on the case.
But a full steward's inquiry will take place.
Yeah, and we are assured. Video evidence.
Yeah.
Because basically, when I see Randy and Peter, kind of mincing about to the song from Amarillo.
That's what they do, isn't it? They mince, the gays.
They mince terribly on that, and the bit with the gorilla at the end, that was kind of like very, you know, mincy, I thought. But basically, it looks like he's not really a fat bastard. He looks about the same weight as Chappers, really, doesn't he?
Maybe.
No, I don't know. So, JB, cheers, mate. Anyway, we'll give it an investigation next week. All right.
Yeah.
Cheers,
mate.
Anyway.
Cheers, mate. I need to talk to you during the week via instant message, by the way, about the videos. But I'll do that on Monday, Tuesday.
Right? Oh, how boring was that comment?
Okay. Sorry, mate. Take care.
Bye.
Yes. Well, we are trying to. Yes.
Oh, good man.
Go away. Stop it. Stop it. We'll talk to you off air.
See you, mate. Ta-da.
Hello.
Good evening.
You ain't gonna believe it, sir. It's me again,
mate.
Matt.
No, I ain't gonna believe it. And get rid of it. And don't call again tonight, Chris. Don't call. No, get Stu. Stu, foot down, Stu. Thank you. Don't call again tonight. You're pissing me off.
Voila.
Well, I've got a load of rubbish. Do you know what I mean?
Touchy, touchy.
Sorry. Actually, I'm not going
to
say it.
Aaron wants to reposition.
I just wanted to remind.
Go on, say it. Go on, say it. You know you
want
to.
Let him have it.
Go on, say it.
So, what are the hot topics tonight?
Who cares?
No, seriously. What are they?
No, who cares?
I've not actually said anything.
Who cares?
About any of them.
Well, doesn't. Who cares?
But were they? Al-Fayed?
Al-Fayed. We've done that.
And bus stops?
Yeah. Bus stops, we've done that.
And what else?
Freedom of speech.
Freedom of speech. We're always doing that.
Yeah.
I feel, though, that we're maybe not giving Chris his freedom of speech.
Well, no, but that's just it. That's not speech.
You have given him his freedom of speech, and all he did was wasted it.
Yeah. Who's on the phone?
We normally use the words ass, damn, hell, and bitch. We will never, however, use the words shit, fuck, goddamn, Jesus Christ, faggot, or any other racial or sexual slurs. Now then, as it pertains to video, we promise there will be less dick references. Ah, shit. What you fucking mean, what? Fuck me. God damn it. Fuck.
Yeah, that'll do. Thank you.
Sound quality could have been slightly better, but nice.
Speech. Freedom of speech?
Freedom of speech. What Chris is doing, other than pissing me off, is clogging up the lines and putting a load of shite on what could perfectly be a perfectly good random talk show without him. And if he doesn't call in tonight, or again, I don't think we miss anything.
Fair enough.
I'm still trying to think of that. So you're all going,
oh, don't alienate a listener. Oh, don't alienate somebody. Why the fuck not?
No, it's a joke connected to that Madonna track. It's hilarious.
Shall we stand on some scales, Stu? Okay. I've had beer now, so I'll immediately weigh like 9 million pounds now.
£9 million?
Yeah.
How on earth do you deduce, Joe, that you will weigh £9 million?
I've given up. I've been trying to lose weight. I've been stuck at the same position for weeks.
If you weighed £9 million, we wouldn't have got you through the car gate in the building,
that's
let alone...
That's very
the
true.
And if you're weighing £9 million, there's no way I'm giving you a lift home tonight. My suspension won't take it, love. Right.
And you do look absolutely gorgeous. I did say that when you got here, off air. I'm not just being sleazy on.
Here I am,
just
wearing a brown jumper. It's great.
Wow. She scrubs up well, our Joe, for a Scot.
What do you mean for a Scot? Listen, I'm not that far from being Scottish myself, so just
be careful. How are you? Hang on, you either are or you aren't. You aren't, so there you are not. And there you are, further from being a Scot than everybody else in this room, apart from Joe, who is actually a Scot.
I'm much closer to being a Scot than your lanky Leicestershire arse.
Oh, really?
Yes.
How long did you live in Scotland for?
I didn't. I lived in Newcastle.
Oh, really? I lived in Scotland for 4 years. Helensburgh, just around the corner from the submarine base.
Really?
You lived where?
Yeah.
Newcastle?
But living there.
Born Newcastle.
But living there.
Yes,
make
means
it.
I'm just as much of a Scot as you. We're not Scots. I swear to God, people, the hell will rain down upon you. No, you're not Scottish.
Everyone's
I'm not
Scottish,
Scottish.
Really.
Living there doesn't mean
sake.
To say you are Scottish.
Have you got a bit of English in you, Joe?
From the weekend.
One so fantastic. I mentioned to Stu before we went on air, by the way. What's this for an idea? When weight loss challenge is over and none of us can be arsed and you're going to be fat again, what we're going to do is we're going to move the show on a nice sunny day outside. We're going to do the show outside on a picnic table and that. We're going to have a barbie.
Sounds good.
We're going to invite a few friends. We're going to have a few beers. We're all going to catch taxis. And we're just going to have a bit of a party, but we're going to put some mics there and make it on air.
Sounds great. Yeah. That's really good.
Perfect.
Right, let's weigh, you fat bastards and see how fat you are.
I want to use...
I am 10 stone yet again.
I want to use my weigh from this morning. Because the one I've been sending in just lately has been my morning weigh.
My one's been the morning one as well. If I could use this morning's one...
Because when I do it here, it's always bigger and heavier.
You've got to do it here. That means that you've eaten too much shit during the day. You've got to do it here. You've got to do it live.
I'm forgetting bolognese.
It's what is happening now that counts.
On the phone, hello. Thank you for phoning in at the wrong moment.
But there's no... Scandinavians.
There's no say that those videos that we're getting off the other people are even done today. Done now?
Well, this is what the steward's inquiry is looking at.
See?
We are doing it as per regulations. Not that we have those.
And I tell you, person...
Well, that means we've got to starve ourselves all day.
I tell you, person, whoever you might be, we're on to you. We know you're cheating, and we're going to expose you. Well, you're not on a fucking mic!
Well, if you shut up, people will be able to hear me!
Ladies and gentlemen, Fat Boy Heron.
Fuck off.
Come on.
I'm finished.
Oh. What's the point of that? Yeah, whoever you are, we're on to you. We've got your number. Your days are marked.
17 marked.
See, this morning, mine was 15.6.
Are you getting on now, Aaron?
This morning I made like 7.5 stone and I just had a pizza.
Oh, yeah, you did.
No. This morning I fell out of bed and floated to the ground like a feather. No doubt it'll be the same now.
And I'm going to be massive now.
You are.
Well, get on with it. We've only got 45 seconds left of the music.
There's no point in weighing us older. The scales won't even pick her up.
Yes, because the scales don't measure the negative value. This old has to weigh heavy boots to keep her on the ground.
Yeah, that's a bit.
You like that, did you?
Like that.
Yeah.
Okay.
You've got shoes on, though. You've got shoes on.
16, you've got your shoes on there.
I know. Do you want to redo it? But naked this morning, I was 15.6.
Well, I'm forced.
Noses, everybody.
Shoes are on. God, he's taking his shoes off. Quick, get the aircon blowing that way. Yeah, the judging by Joe's face.
Yeah, that wasn't so good.
You
I know, I'm just rethinking that whole situation.
Come on, I'm wearing an extra jumper. 10-2!
10-2. In answer to the question in the Skype chat room, we don't know anybody's cheating. We're just saying there's going to be a steward's inquiry into some people's results. More than one.
There is a mole.
Not just zero. Not just one competitor, but possibly two, if not three.
If not all of the cheating bastards.
If not all of us, yeah.
The only ones, in fact, that I know aren't cheating are the three in this room now that I can see their blooming results.
And our disappointment week after week, apart from yours, of course.
I would like to unposition ourselves, if that's all right.
Go on, then. You unposition yourself.
The
away,
phone then. Number isn't 01243556060, nor is it 02081231088. You can't email us on studio@playradio.com. And if you've got Skype, you're fucked.
And if you want to call us on our weight loss challenge number, it's 1-800-FAT-BASTARD.
Yeah, yes, indeed. and if you're the cheating one, it's 999.
Cheating
we're
two.
Not, we're
There's
not.
More than one.
Oh, a cheating person. So if you're a cheating one, doesn't mean that there is only one person, if you are one of them.
Yeah.
And we haven't got any hot topics. We won't be talking about the freedom of speech. So none of you are allowed to say anything whatsoever. This isn't an internet radio talk show. And you can't watch it all at nttbs.com. I'm unpositioned.
Thank you, Ben. Thank you, Ben, on Skype for giving away my secret of setting the scales by 2 stone lighter.
So I'm actually 12-2.
No, don't say that. I have been trying to. I can't get out because I've been marking on my bloody students' work, so I can't exercise at
see
all.
What you've done?
It's really annoying.
No.
So hang on a minute. So what you're saying is we've got a weight gate.
A weight gate?
Weight gate. Oh. Who's on the phone? Yeah, but right, well, you see that one there. Leave it on hold and what make his phone bill cost something. Because it's goddamn revenge. Right. That's what it is. Rack up a nice phone.
Waitgate.
Oh, and right. Anyway, no one was saying anybody there was cheating. We were saying there's going to be a steward's inquiry.
Because 50 quid is up for grabs.
You know full well, right, Stu is you know, he's the diplomatic one. I'm saying someone's cheating and I'm saying we're gonna fucking find you.
Play Radio Security does have your number, and you will be getting a visit.
Yeah, that's right.
We're going to make you get on the scales.
We're
going
to send Alan Caddick round to strip off naked for you. Maybe molest your other half.
That'd be nice. Jingle. That'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Right, okay. Let's make up a topic.
Spit it out, then.
Let's make up a topic. Don't you think it's weird the way that the moon is disintegrating?
What? Is it?
Yeah, I said make up a topic, Aaron.
All right.
So you think it's weird?
I like topics.
It's smaller every night. You like topics? All right. I'm a Star Bar fan. Definitely
I used to be a Milky Way fan before they changed it to that crappy white inside. It was much nicer when it was the chocolate one inside.
Did they used to have chocolate inside?
Yeah. They were brown inside as opposed to white. Yeah.
Big fan of a double decker.
They're all right. Boosts are okay. Mm. The caramel whisper. No,
don't want to drop a Lion Bar in the local swimming pool. You'll cause a bit of a fuss.
Oh, Lion Bar peanut. They're nice. They're nice. Lion Bar peanut. Right. Let's see how many chocolate bars we can roll off.
Picnic.
Boost.
Mars.
Whisper.
Kit Kat.
Snickers.
Twix.
Sorry, Twix. You said Twix, that's you.
Yeah.
Hang on, but let's start again, going in a relevant order. Okay, so I'll start. Dairy milk.
Fruit and nut.
Turkish Delight.
Galaxy. Twix.
Boost.
Fries.
Kit Kat.
Bounty.
Fantastic.
One more go. Go on.
Okay, you want me to start?
No, I'm going to start.
You want to start?
We'll go around this way, right?
Just chocolate bars.
Just chocolate bars. Galaxy.
Whisper.
Bueno.
Curly Whirly.
Turkish Delight.
Twix.
Lime Bar.
Sorry.
Oh, it's actually harder than you think, isn't it?
Let me stop now. I've eaten chocolate in months now.
One more. One more. Go on, and start with Aaron.
Kit Kat Chunky.
Mars.
Twix.
Snickers.
Whole nut.
Oh, I don't know.
Nah, this is going nowhere. Take a call.
We are shit, aren't we?
It's rubbish.
On the phone, hello.
I've got a topic for you. Chewy Law.
Why does everybody get so bad about this? What's wrong with Sharia law? What's wrong with talking about Sharia law?
This is best call all night.
We spent an entire programme almost having to talk about Sharia law.
Well, no, actually, we spent about
two minutes on it.
We spent about 2 minutes on it. The rest of the programme was about how you didn't want to talk about it.
It was more a case of I looked at Joe and Joe looked at me and we just went, we couldn't give a shit.
What's wrong with having a serious debate?
And that kind of killed the whole debate.
I could give a shit. I could give a shit if the police had to treat Muslims differently to us.
Yeah.
I give a shit. Are you on the phone?
No, this is Ian Wone.
Ian Wone, how are you, Ian Wone?
Yeah.
I've been mentioned a few times in the Skype chat room, so I wondered if it's best to call in.
I'd
have preferred it if you were Ugo Ekiog, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah, or Carol Poborski.
Andre Salenzi.
Or anybody but Ian Wone, actually. Anybody but... I don't think Ian Wone should be spoken to. He should be an enigma. He should be out there in the ether. But not actually known. He should just.
Not really, Ian Wone, it's me. I thought I'd try a voice for once.
Yeah, it was crap, G-Man.
Yeah. Oh,
and so
G-Man.
And so were your last two calls. Is this one going to be any better?
Snickers, by the way.
We already said Snickers.
Go on, we can do a G-Man.
Go okay,
on.
So okay, right.
G-Man starts. Ready?
G-Man starts. Then it goes me, Joe, Aaron, Isolde, and then when Stu says, then it's you again, G-Man. Yeah.
Right. Okay then.
All right. Snickers. Go on. Do it again, G-Man.
Snickers.
Caramac.
Shit, that's what I was going to say. That's not chocolate, it's disqualified. Whisper, move on.
Fries, chocolate cream.
That'll do.
Turkish Delight.
Bounty.
You finished. You jumped in there. You went wrong.
See, you forgot.
So
oh, hey, G-Man was there. You
shit. Thanks, G-Man.
Shut up.
Chris, favourite chocolate bar, Chris.
Never mind all that.
Okay, bye.
We're doing chocolate bars.
Topic.
There you go. Boost.
Kit Kat.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
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 Yeah. Have you got anything to come back with here?
I didn't hear what you said.
You know
Chris,
what? Where's Chaz and Dave's rabbit when you need it? Rabbit.
Jibber jabber.
Yeah. Sorry.
Chris,
sorry,
do you get free phone calls?
Hey.
Chris, do you get free phone calls on this phone, or is this call costing you? Right, put him back on hold for a bit. And if he's got to pay for the call, put him on hold. That's it, and then take that one. Yeah. Hello.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Favourite chocolate bar?
Right.
Mars.
Matt?
Boost.
I don't know any more. We need some more chocolate bar. We've got whiskers.
Flying saucer.
Joe couldn't be any less interested, could he, love?
You know, there are.
I have not been allowed to eat chocolate for ages, so you know, I just don't care.
Don't worry, next week you can do what you like. You know, they're bringing out a soft drink called cocaine.
Yeah, I saw that.
It's meant to give you the same buzz as cocaine. And
do you drink it or do you snort it?
I'm sure that Alan Caddick will have a problem deciding, and we'll find out quite rapidly that you drink it. But yeah, apparently it's meant to give you the same buzz as cocaine. Tonight on Not the Tommy Boyd Show from the BBC website, we're asking, is this responsible? And now we're repositioning with 01243 55 60 60, studio at playradiouk.com, play.radio.uk on Skype, 02081231088, and nttbs.com to watch it all happen.
It's fucking gas and sausages.
Oh, that's one for the quotes, isn't it?
Who fucks gas and sausages?
Not the same time.
I'm trying to talk to you, Chris. The problem is, mate, is that...
No, you're trying to be fucking smart, you are.
No, you have a go at me, sir.
Hello?
Hello?
I'll have a go at you any time you like. Sure, I thought you were a nice kid.
I thought you needed your fucking profile.
And what are you doing now? Just taping this for in between?
No.
Because I tell you what, I've got some points, mate. You know when you're on a...
No, you haven't, Chris.
You know, when you misappropriated...
No, don't get all worried. He doesn't care.
No.
I'm
going to
tell you
what
we know about gear makers. We're from the middle of the fucking gear maker. We could go to space if you want to know, you know?
Yes.
But you don't want to. You want to fucking be smart. Because I think you're half a puff.
Who is?
You.
Me?
Yeah, now the daughter. Yeah, you got children on the way. I think you're half a puff.
No, you think so?
Well, I know you ain't broadcasting it, so I'm going to say what I fucking like. Nice one, cheers, Rob. Is it still raining? I don't
want to
talk about gears, anyone.
I don't
want to
talk to you.
I'm putting
this up in hyperspace.
I know, well, what's going...
I don't want to fucking in that.
Well, what's going on in hyperspace, then?
What's going on? Well, wait until...
Stu, you're trying, mate, and I appreciate the fact that you're trying, but it still ain't happening, and it still ain't going anywhere, so just get rid.
Me. I
want
to talk to you. You don't
want
to talk to me.
No, you don't want to talk to us. No, you don't want to talk to us. What you want is a forum for your bullshit. Because I tell you what, you're funny. You're funny in small doses, mate.
You and your fucking G-Man had a go. I have rung up in response to G-Man.
Right, I am blocking his number with BT. I'm sick.
I think G-Man's a bit of a tosser.
I think you're a bit of a tosser. Now stop ringing us and hassling us. This is verging on stalking. Stu, will you please? It is verging on stalking, this is. I'd rather have Alan Caddick.
Don't mention that station. You've done it twice now.
Which station has he talked about?
Talks.
Oh, right, converging on, I get it, yeah. That's really funny, and what
please.
You've actually done, Aaron...
Can you stop
No,
it?
What you've actually done...
No, you're doing it again.
Why? What
let's,
have I
let's
said
just
it?
Forget
move
it.
On. Forget it, move hey. On.
No.
You did it twice.
Chappers.
And what you've actually done is now made it aware. You're barred.
All right, I'll not be
Chappers.
Here next
is
week.
Is there somebody on the line?
Mr. Chapman, good afternoon.
I make it evening, Stuart.
Well, it's close enough,
good
mate.
Evening.
Good evening.
What can I do
Lots
for you, mate?
Lots of people have been mentioning homosexuality this evening, so I thought I'd call in.
Yes, you are gay, after all.
Cheers.
It's nice, isn't it?
I think I've come up with the theory of why Chris is like how he is now.
Okay.
I think he's a bit depressed and desperate because he's not part of the clique, the inner circle. He's on the outs.
He's on the outside.
What do you mean, clique, inner circle?
Is he an outsider?
The clique or the inner circle?
What is the clique or the inner circle?
Well, apparently,
Ask Headless.
So apparently, the clique. Apparently, so some of the shall we say? Okay, so there's a bit of a, there's a controversy going on.
Oh no, I know where you're going.
So there's a controversy going on in the Skype chat room, and there's a bit of a war going on between the people in the Skype chat room and the people in the On the Wireless chat room. And the people that are in the On the Wireless chat room are now considered to be the clique. Basically by people who've been banned from the On the Wireless chat room, I hasten to add, right? So, okay. And apparently I'm in the clique because I met a bunch of the people at the On the Wireless chat room while I was watching Ian's taping a couple of weeks ago.
Right.
And so apparently that's it now. There's a clique and then there's a Skype crew, and you can't be in both.
We need to take an outbreak. We need to take an outbreak, Stu. Yeah. And before you hit the outbreak, if Chaffers is quite happy to hold on, you're now going to hit the outbreak right after I've said, you lot need to get a fucking life.
You're on the air, Susan, you know that.
I know I am, and I wanted to ask, you were talking about democracy in your last call.
Yeah.
What are your restrictions on this station? What can you and can't you say?
Well, I'll tell you, Susan, as far as I know, the laws of the land apply, so I can't...
What about the laws of broadcasting?
There is no such thing. If I wanted to say f***, I could say it. I mean, I wouldn't say it, but because somebody may have apoplexy, but that's how free it is.
The James Well Radio Show, Tuesday, 6 till 10 PM UK time, only on PlayTwoUK. This is not the Tommy Boyd Show with Stu and Matt on PlayTwoUK. Beware, the contents of this show may offend.
We're on.
Yeah, I'll tell you, it hurt for ages, and I could have sworn he never used lube.
It's those low-cost hookers again, isn't it?
Do you know what? I could have, Chapman's very trusting, you know.
Why?
Because I left his fader up the entire ad break there, and he didn't utter a word.
Fantastic, Chapman, well done.
Fugger.
You know, one day, Chapman, with skills like that, you might even make it near a radio station yourself.
I was thinking in my head, hearing the James Well advert, I was thinking... That's not the way to advertise a show. You need a jingle.
Go on then.
Proper jingle.
Are you gonna sing us a jingle, Chappers?
No, I'm not gonna sing you my superb ripped off from the James Well guy song.
Chappers.
All right. Okay.
Chappers. Hello, the King of Radio. How are you?
I'm all right. Can I say thank you for my mention?
The King of Talk
Radio.
Hang
on. Can I just play this one? Hang on.
James Well. The James Well Radio Show. You're live on the air. Hi. How are you? Hello?
Hello, James Well, show on Play Radio UK.
Is that the singing one you were on about?
That's the one?
It's brilliant.
That's you?
Yep.
I like that, that's good. That's
helping
good.
To turn the listeners off in their droves.
Yeah, thanks for that.
Pleasure.
Do I get anything...
5p each time that's played?
Do you get 5p? No, you...
Oh, 6p did you say, brilliant.
No, you get a credited phone call to the top of... You get to be James Wells number one.
I need to get a number one back, don't I?
Yeah, you do need a number one back, mate. Yeah,
I lost out, yeah.
Is there anything you've called up, any reason, Chappers, for you being on the end of the line here?
Well, to be honest, listening to Aaron and Christopher, anyone can just phone up and hang out. But no,
I know.
Okay, seriously, I've had something in reserve for about 3 months now that I haven't used. And of course, to be honest, no one's really jumping on topics this evening. Can I bring my conversation piece to the table?
Of course you can. Go on, mate.
Okay, I have an Xbox 360.
Right.
Of course, there are other games consoles available as well.
Yes, of course, though you can get other very reputable games consoles from other
reputable dealers.
Don't take
it too far, guys.
Anyway, okay, you can get a live vision camera for it. Basically, it's a webcam.
Which you probably can from all the other consoles as well. Just
all right, you made your point.
Okay, please calm down. Right. let me say my fun story.
Go on,
story.
Get on with it, yeah.
Okay, there is a game called Uno. Uno the card game.
Yes, yeah, I know very well.
Okay, if you play on the Xbox and you have the camera, your pictures, the four players' pictures appear on the screen so you can see each other.
Right.
So, and also, if you meet people via that and play that game, you can go into private chats. Now, my friend, who also has a webcam for the Xbox, we were in a game with some woman who was kind of hideous, and he suddenly disappeared with her, and he left the game. And they went to a private video chat. So on your TV screen, it's split in two. One side you can see yourself, and the other you can see the other person.
Right.
Now, I didn't realise this until my friend came back from this private chat video screening, is that on the Xbox controller, when you're talking privately to someone, by pressing the shoulder buttons, you can make the other person's controller vibrate.
No!
If you press the left shoulder button, it's a light vibration. If you press the right shoulder button, it's a heavy vibration. And both together, it does some random thing.
Wow. I see where this is going.
So, you can never guess, this woman stripped off. I take my friend's word for it, he's not a liar. And the friend isn't me, it genuinely was a friend, because I'd not be lucky enough to get invited in private chat because of my big mouth.
You beat me to it, Chapman.
Yeah, my mouth, you know, gets me in trouble, so I can't really, you know, be appealing to the ladies. Men, maybe, but ladies, no. So she was placing the controller somewhere sensitive and requesting that he mixes up pressing the shoulder buttons.
Wow.
So the Xbox, just not for gaming.
So this is the Xbox
toy.
So this is the Xbox 360. It's which game?
It's open. I don't know.
Yeah, I was just wondering whether or not Aaron would mind taking over if I nipped down a PC World.
Well, I'll tell you what. Why don't I go and get us two, and I'll bring you the receipt and give me the cash.
Okay, as long as you're not the one that's in the private chat, then you'll be right.
No, I'm just getting the Xbox.
That's
two.
Good. I can deal with that.
What's wrong with your head? Is that real, Chapman?
Yeah. But so why on earth did the Microsoft, obviously Microsoft make the Xbox? Why would they have put that feature in? No, for a private chat, you could press your shoulder button.
I couldn't. Let me tell you.
No, you don't even know what. No, after you.
What I was going to say was that there are a bunch of sad, lonely computer programmers who've got nothing better to do than get turned on by a vibrating controller on a computer.
Shall I tell you something? IPTV is now obviously making quite a big sort of splash, let's say, in the TV industry with the BT Home Hub box and on-demand television and stuff like that. There is soon to be a TV box out there which will be streaming a lot of hardcore porn. I have seen these attachments, right? There's a USB port on the back of this box that streams the TV. And into this box, you plug a USB-corded dildo.
Oh,
or
really?
Fake vagina. You use it while you're watching the porn, and every time there's a movement, it echoes the movement through the USB port and into the implement that you're using to stimulate yourself.
You can already buy that for the PC.
Well, there you go. Apparently, I never knew it before.
I forget which website it was on, but it's on one of those gadget websites where, not being vulgar, nothing here, but you get a replica vagina. And a replica penis.
Aspies.
Then the replica vagina and the replica penis can have sex.
Aspies. Well, no. Would they work better if they vibrated?
So you give the female obviously the penis version, and the bloke has a bloke kind of sticks the, you know, the thing on the end of his knob, and while he does that, the other end does that.
and then when it's all over, the guy stamps on the floor and shouts, "Was that all right for you, love?"
So that was that. Yeah.
That's very good, Chapman.
So may I ask the ladies' point of view? I mean, I'm sure Joe and your other guests would not want to necessarily admit that they'd be interested in doing such a thing, but can you imagine that women would want to be degrading themselves to men on their cameras and their headsets by getting another man to make their controller vibrate?
Not personally.
No.
Come on, Isolde, speak up. Come on, you've been very timid. That's good work, Chapman, bringing the ladies into the room. It's about bloody time.
So, what was the question?
Would you use one?
No.
Or not, you know, just ladies in general. Why would ladies want to, I mean, they mustn't think very highly of themselves. They're prepared to, you know, get involved in such activities.
It's the internet.
I suppose the bloke might not either, seeing as he is doing it over the internet.
See, the strange thing that I always find with those things, I've never taken part in anything like that, because you don't know who's just off webcam.
Mm.
I mean, it could be a whole room of people you can't see. She might be a hired stripper. No, and someone,
or
your mate's just having a joke with you. They've paid 50 quid for a stripper to come down and take her clothes off while they can all video, like, record you wanking and stick it on YouTube.
Yeah. Yeah, it'd be good.
Yeah, but then surely your mates are the sad ones for wanting to film you wank.
I don't know, it's quite a good setup, really, isn't it? Thank you very much, Chapman.
Cheers, I was mate. Researching. I've got more.
Yeah, go
oh, Jesus.
Anyway, yeah, there's a serious side to this now, a disappointing side. I was doing some research about it.
Uh-huh.
It might have been on the BBC website or somewhere else.
My favourite place.
It seems that men are actually paying, like, girls via PayPal, young girls, to go on these cameras on the Xbox. Need I say more?
No, that's gross.
That's nice, thanks. That's a nice thought there.
Sorry,
thanks.
But, you know...
No, it's true. We
should cover the serious side.
No, I completely agree with you, Chapman. It's about bloody time someone agreed with me on the whole serious thing and probably
Chapman, are we,
random bullshit zoo friends.
Yeah, here we go, look. Part of the click, mate, the click.
The click, yeah, the click. What fucking click, Jesus.
When are we going for a beer, chappers?
I don't know. Oh, Ryu has asked, is Ian Wone in the click?
No. Click doesn't exist. It's in people's heads. you shouldn't really go for a beer with your listeners.
Chapman,
why is that? To keep them at arm's length.
Yeah?
Chapman,
you
just
can,
Chapman.
In a pub. Sorry.
You just ruined my whole joke.
Pete,
sit the other side of the table.
My name's got an R at the end, Stuart.
Peter, sorry.
Ooh, the real Peter Chapman.
Peter.
Hi, my name is...
Sorry, mate. Listen, quick yes or no on that suggestion that was made to you the other day.
People make suggestions to him all the time.
Is that it?
Is that the yes or no?
I thought you were going to ask me about weight loss.
Oh, well, what about... Well, oh, yeah, how is your weight loss? Anyway, yeah, what is your weight? You didn't put it in your vid, did you?
I have chosen to withhold my weight for this week because... I want to surprise you next week, Stuart.
Sorry. Thanks, mate. Thanks.
I don't want you knowing how much you need to lose. So I'm holding it.
Right, I see. Just for the benefit of Isolde, this is the guy that is like 0.5% ahead of me or behind me.
So behind.
He's behind. Well, he was behind last week, but who knows now? Because I've only lost a pound this week.
You've only lost a pound?
Yes.
Oh, damn, I've given it away by sounding excited.
Brilliant. Thank you very much for that, Chappers.
Chappers, I have the private eye outside your house.
Yeah, the finale is next week. So we will be finding out. Take care, mate.
We've got to battle through a bunch of these.
Get rid of the first one, because he's paid enough now. No,
I've done that. It's
fine.
All
right, okay.
So, let's go. Hello on the phone.
Hello. This is... Lord Moggy and Transmystic all in one.
Hello, mate, how are you? Alan.
Sorry?
I said, how, mate? How are you?
I'm good, thank you. And how are you?
I'm good. How's Poland?
It's looking pretty good. It's improving every day.
Don't lie.
I'm not lying. I'm serious.
No, you are full of it.
No, I'm not. I'm sitting
here. No, you're Australian. You're full of it.
Is it better than Australia?
No, but then that's Poland.
Well, that much is true, yeah, you got that, yeah. What can I do for you, mate?
I just wanted to say hello and sort of pop in and say hello to all the crew.
Hello.
Hello. And Alan seems to think that I am not Transmystic and I'm not Lord Moggy, so...
Oh, stop reading the Skype forums and make the call worth something, Transmystic, before we cut you off. We're in that mood.
Matt is.
You're in that mood, are you?
Yeah, make it worth it, Trans.
Yeah, that's me, it's me.
Cool.
You're missing the whole point here. 01243 55.
Trans, it's good to hear from you, mate. Talk to you soon, alright?
Okay, man.
Ta-da.
Why did you try that one just to say hello?
Hello.
God, thank God for that.
Hello. Hello on the phone. Yes, that's
thank
you.
Thank God for that. Every time you press that button, I think...
Hello.
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 Is that me, mate?
No, yes. It's not you. See you later.
Hello, but no, don't do that.
Why?
Because I've got a point to make in...
No, you haven't. Mate. You start the conversation with that every time. You've got a point to make, then it goes absolutely nowhere. Go away. Go to bed or something.
Mate.
I don't know.
No, it doesn't.
No, I tell you what, I need a stick, Stu, so I can poke that button and just get rid of him, because you're not... Thank you.
Hello.
Keep rolling, rolling, rolling. Listen, look at it, yeah. Are we all ready in there?
Yeah, sure.
We're off air and all that, ready for... No, you haven't touched the settings, have you?
If you touch them settings, Ross, you'll be in trouble,
thank
mate.
Thank you.
good. Eduardo, hello.
Good evening.
Good... Oh, blimey, you on off basey tonight, evening. Mate. Good evening.
Well, don't compensate for it there. Leave it there. He needs to compensate for it. It's like on his side, because otherwise people get to work in the morning and all the settings are off.
I'll put it back to normal.
You don't know, do you?
Hello. Anyway, mate, how are you?
I'm fine. I was wondering about that sex stimulator attached to your computer.
Yeah.
I had the idea the other day while watching a movie.
It's like someone beat you to it, mate.
Well, that's what I'm disappointed about, because I was seriously thinking investing some money into it and patenting it, but I'm disappointed to find out that someone is beating me to it.
Well, no,
there is always a fat, spotty guy behind a computer with glasses that's always looking for the next sexual invention, Stu.
Well, I was thinking about one for the gay market. I think that's been...
right.
So what you're saying is... A vibrating insertion machine or something.
So what you're saying is two penises. Rather than the penis and the vagina version.
Double-ended.
I wasn't going to go that far. You seem to know a lot about it, but I was just thinking of the one.
Matt taught me.
I taught him well as well, mate. He knows what he's doing. I'll tell you what. They don't call him the colonostomator for nothing.
No, that's right, exactly. Eduardo, how was your appearance on the air last night?
Oh, tiring.
Was it?
Yeah, I left at Hull. I was in Hull. Have you ever been to Hull?
No, they've just won the championship playoff final, so well done, Hull.
Apparently so, and there was an awful lot of blokes that are definitely northern with T-shirts at 3 o'clock in the morning, covered in tattoos, stumbling around a kebab shop, and it was very frightening for a soft southern Jesse like myself.
Southern fairies, that's what we call you.
Get out of there, I would. I skedaddle down the motorway at 3 o'clock, trying to keep my eyes awake. I passed Leicester, that's where you're from, isn't it?
Oh, did it smell of curry?
It was awful.
Yeah, I'm not surprised, mate. Yeah. It is absolutely... I tell you what, the one saving grace about Leicester is that you're only passing it for 20 minutes on the M1. It's only 20 minutes you have to put up with it.
Well, I've never been that far north, not for a long time. And
did
I
get altitude sickness?
No, I was impressed. I really did think it was sort of black and white up there. Mm. But it's not. It is colour.
They have colour TV.
That's Newcastle.
I'm not actually north. I'm from the Midlands. So,
it's north to us, though.
Anything north of the Watford Gap is north, all right?
Yeah, anything north of the Watford Gap you don't know about because you're southern and stupid and you haven't read a map.
Pardon?
Sorry, I'm just having a go at Stu. You know what I'm like.
Oh, you're cranky tonight, aren't you?
I'm not cranky. Have you eaten? I'm actually in a very good mood, and I feel like I'm on top form, but I'm just not standing for any shit, mate. That's it.
Cranky puss, aren't you?
That cut out at perfectly the right time. we're gonna get some of your music on,
Eduardo.
Maybe you
could have one of my... Lovely. Maybe you could have one of my new anal insertion things to soothe you.
Yeah.
Vibrating butt plug.
Mm. Yeah, we could.
You could remove your penis with the aid of a blunt knife.
Now, I don't know if you remember that there was going to be the Matt Hollick public challenge where Matt Hollick was going to do something for public research
every week, and it never
went anywhere.
Do you know why?
Because we asked him to do anal bleaching on the first week, and he wasn't prepared to do it.
No, do you know why? No, this is happening. It's because I actually have a job, unlike a lot of people. I actually have a job that takes up a hell of a lot of time, and I don't actually have... I would love, right, to spend one day not doing my normal job and dedicate it purely to doing stuff for this show, stupid stuff like that. I don't have that day, I don't have that time, so unfortunately, I can't do this stuff.
You can't
find the time. You probably sleep, don't you?
Sorry?
Do you sleep?
About 6 hours a night.
Hello?
Far too much. Eduardo, thanks very much, mate.
Ciao.
I'll talk to you soon, alright. Let's rattle through a couple of calls.
Hello? No, brilliant.
Hello?
Okay, brilliant. Ad break time. It's just great. The last two ad breaks, we had Chris and Alan, we go into an ad break. Sorry, Alan, what?
You know you were talking about sexual stimulation?
Yeah. Oh, who'd have fucking guessed it?
For a cheap
hooker. Who'd have guessed it? Alan?
£25.
For a cheap hooker?
Yeah.
Were you curb crawling again,
for
Alan?
Half an hour.
Alan, were you curb crawling again?
No, it's all completely legal. Ban another in the paper and all that.
Right.
All completely legal.
So it's completely legal that she's charging for sex as a prostitute. But it's completely legal because she advertises in the local paper.
Yeah.
Doesn't mean so.
Under discreet massage.
Is there more than one girl working from the establishment where you go to pay to get your discreet massage?
There's two maximum.
Right, then I'm afraid that is actually illegal because the law on prostitution says that it's okay for one woman to work from a place of employment, but not for two.
Well, I don't know. They should be shutting these things down.
Did she give you it good, Alan?
I'll film it on my mobile and I'll send you a link on YouTube.
Yeah, thanks for that, mate.
I think therein lies the problem of Alan being single.
Hello?
Is that you?
Yes, it's me. And Matt's not here. What can I do?
What are you doing there? Can I really make a point?
Go on then.
Right. Well, it's quite a comical point.
Right.
What are you doing? You wait to get to the adverts.
No, we're waiting for you to make your comical point.
Well, I know that, but, you know, you do fuck about with people, if you don't mind me saying so.
Well, you know, I try my best.
What are you doing now? You're just checking answers in them halfway through.
No, I'm listening to you. Go for it. Do it now before he comes back.
Go for it.
Go for it.
Aye. Anyway, what you do is you say... Now, you know about gears, yeah?
Yeah.
We come from what you call the industrial heartland. And we know more about gears than you're ever going to fucking know in your life.
Right.
Right, here.
Isolde's coming up next.
Did you know you can now have your windows at home or at work professionally cleaned for as little as £1.50 per window without damaging the environment? Window and Wheelie do it greener and cleaner with state-of-the-art pure water technology using no detergents, chemicals or ladders, with the added bonus that your windows stay cleaner for longer, leaving you more time for business or pleasure. Our operatives may be cleaning in your area right now, so give the Wheelie Bin and Window Cleaning Company a call on 08702 437 691 or visit windowandwheelie.co.uk for more details.
Play Radio UK have teamed up with Virgin Wines to offer you a massive £20 discount off your favourite wines. Visit playradiouk.com/virginwines to start saving now and get your favourite wines delivered to your door. Play Radio UK and Virgin Wines for people who love their wine and a great deal. PlayRadioUK.com/Virgin Wines.
For perfect personalised cards for any occasion delivered through the letterbox, go to PlayRadioUK.com/Moonpig.
It's not the Tommy Boyd Show with Matt and Stu, only on Play2UK. Beware, the content of this show may offend.
Right, it's Joe and I and Aaron for a second while Matt helps us all to get set up in the other studio and ready to rock. If yes. I fade that up there. Oh, are we on?
Gooey.
Lovely.
Oh, okay. I could just hear her practicing there. So,
excellent.
Yeah, so it's 01243 55 66. You've got 15 minutes left. You want to give us a call?
I do want to say something.
Matt wants to say something very quickly, and then it's Isolde.
Okay, we don't screen calls here. You go straight to her. I think we're pretty fair with that, and we're pretty honest with that, right? But if ever there was a cause for screening calls, it's Chris and Alan. We've got the facilities, right? Treat it with some respect, otherwise we will screen the calls. I think that's fair, don't you?
Hang on, don't let us start. We'll get some pictures.
Oh, right. Oh, okay.
Okay. Isolde, can you hear me?
I can.
That's good. All right. You see, this is the wonderful
modern technology. Can you introduce the song?
I will. What song are you singing, Isolde?
I'm going to sing a song called... Oh. The song I haven't played before, and...
You've forgotten the name.
That's okay. Don't worry. new song.
It's a new song from Isolde. Right, we'll shut up. It's over to you. Go ahead.
Okay. There is something I forgot to say. When the tears have all gone away, I should have thought to use my brain. Instead I fall and my heart breaks again. There is a lesson to be learned. Talking about love once again, just talking about love. I dreamt a sailor came to rescue me from the salty sadness of this lonely sea, but I should have woke up long ago. Suddenly the pain of-
Is that the only one? Are we not having another?
I don't know. Is Ollie, you there?
I am there.
Have you got another one you could do?
Geez, I don't know.
Can you remember the name of it this time, Aaron?
That was called Talking About Love. I remember the words.
It's very nice.
Here comes Aaron. Look, snap happy Aaron.
Snap happy Aaron.
He's a bit of a pervert, but he's our pervert.
if you haven't, Isolde, it's fine. If you want to pop back in again, and we will wrap up the show because we've got 10 minutes. And I've got a couple of callers to take.
Oh,
all right.
Okay.
See you in a moment.
Thank you.
Just to conclude, we could be doing research instead of that. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So, yes. Which is
that
slightly
might
better.
Be better idea.
Yeah.
It was very nice. Thank you. It was brilliant.
Well, woo! All right. Yeah. Woo! Crazy. Hey, enjoyed that. Can you do that? Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Harry.
I'm imagining when you're singing the song, it's in my old flat when I lived in Aberdeen. I had this beautiful Victorian flat with huge ceilings and lovely bay window, and I used to sit drinking a glass of wine and smoke my fag out the window. I was watching all the people going by in the rain, and that sort of reminds me.
That
is a compliment, by the way.
It's a lovely scene to set.
That
is a lovely scene to set.
Are you sure you would have listened to that?
What from one newso to another? Who's best out of you two? I mean,
she's great.
Oh, perfect. I don't think it's a contest.
Well, it's completely different music for a start, so it doesn't
There's
help.
There's only one way to settle this. Fight!
Excellent. We have got one of these to play from the one and only...
A Vedloth Challenge.
Randy-tastic.
Randy-tastic.
A few weeks ago, you may remember a certain bald man... pranked me. It was a good prank, but I wasn't going to take it lying down. Can I have the most intelligent man in the universe, please?
Hello! You can call me a doctor!
Hello, Alan.
This is not where I wanted to be!
If that thing actually works, you'll take me back in time now before I grab something of yours that's going to result in a premature regeneration. You understand?
There's time or regulations that strictly forbid me from tampering with the history of Earth.
You fucking twat. You've parked against my bedroom door. How the fuck am I meant to get in, you cunt?
Holy damn it, I'm a target! Come on! Hello there, listeners. It's March 11th, 2008, and I am going to Skype a wind-up mastermind. Let's see. Oh, bollocks, there's only that Jason of Shrine online. Always thought he was a bit of a strange one. Oh well, if you can't get Mother Teresa, Princess Di, or Harold Shipman, Stephen Hawking's nurse will have to do. Right, Jason, you busy?
Here's the webcam on. Randy?
Listen, I've come back in time with Alan Caddick, and I want you to...
Hang on. You came back in town with Alan Caddick to stop me from finishing my wank.
Shut up, you meathead. Look, I've come back because I want to get revenge on Aaron Weedle. And I want it to sting like a fraternity boy's arse rape.
Well, tonight, Randy, I'm going to be... Oh my God, Leslie, how are you?
I'm actually considering hiding my Vaseline.
That coming at Chucky Jack Harness and I strongly agree on.
Oh, fuck off, Alan! As they say, revenge is a dish best served cold. Or perhaps I should be fucking horrible with a green drink.
Green drink? What's a green drink?
Now, look it up. We'll plan a bit more in the next few weeks. Well, I'm going to take advantage of this time displacement and get absolutely shit-faced. I'm dying to hear what happened with Leslie the past few weeks.
Let me see if I can get some audio. Hang on a minute.
There was a guy phoned in to talk about green drink.
Leslie.
Guess who it is?
Leslie.
Hello, Stuart.
Hello, Leslie.
Oh, no, this isn't her, is it?
I'm not a woman.
You're like our personal life advisor, Leslie.
If Leslie would agree, right, to be our personal trainer, then we would need to hear from Leslie once a week.
It's very good, these weekly tips, to do something different every week.
I did not show my willy.
No, but it was close enough.
How do you do it?
Joe nicely went out this week to buy some P-test papers for next week.
Drink your green drink, for fuck's sake.
I'm not drinking one of your green fucking drinks.
I know what to lube a strap on with, mister.
No. So I spend most of my time on the toilet.
Weird. Yes, yeah. You've got to totally alkalize your
body. Oh, is she still here?
Oh, you patronizing dick. Oh.
Cheers, Leslie.
Bye.
Come on.
Sunday the 20th of April 2008. 2 weeks ago. Right, better Skype Jace.
Oh my god, I was watching Little House on the Prairie.
Fucking hell, Jace. I only meant for you to become a character, not a full-on Marmite miner.
How dare you? It's Mr. Grufod to you. Grufod.
Come up with the most hideously plausible diet you can think of. We'll make out I went on it for a week, and then when the team see the results of the weight I lose, they'll be so amazed, we can stick them on it for a week. Oh yeah, get some laxatives on that as well. If we can make one of them shit themselves in a restaurant, that'd be even better.
I'll come up with a really healthy plan, but it'll be grotesque.
Basically, I want Aaron's bottom as red as Matt's cock when Darts and Ice is on. Oh, and actually, while we're at it, try and convince Stu to do some pissing on litmus paper. That'll be a good one as well.
Well, let's carry on our journey and find out where shall we go now.
Oh, I'm just getting really, really pissed off with Leslie coming out the same crap every week about green fucking drink.
Are you willing to put your money where your mouth is, Randy?
You do your little tips this week for a week. I'll take them up.
I'll do better than that, Randy. I've actually got a 5-day cleanse programme. Come back to us next week.
Okay, you're on.
But Randy better have done the fucking diet. If this works for Randy...
Yeah, right, this week, yeah, I'll do it.
You're going to do it.
Yes.
Right, don't worry if you found it revolting, because that's not what this is about.
Okay, yeah, no worries, I'll do it, I'll do it.
That is £6 gone.
In a week.
Take it all back.
Bloody hell,
we are done.
Well done, Leslie, and well done, Randy.
All right, I'll give it a crack. I seriously will give it a go.
All right, this is Aaron's week, then.
What's funny is Aaron's lost £6 on my plan, but Stuart has to do real physical exercise to get the same off. What are you going to do now, Randy? You have to seriously lose weight. I have a 10-day bowel cleanse, and you're going to need pH drops, green drink.
To be honest, I'd rather eat my own scrotum, thanks. Maybe we should suggest that to Aaron next time. And that's all for that, readers. Please tune in next week when I'll be shaming the ragamuffin who gave them my number in the first place.
And I'll also be revealing another voice I do. Play the jingle, Stuart!
That's fantastic. So, Stuart Heron in, three Vickers and a Hoover. Hello. Marvellous. Anyway, listen, we've only got 48 seconds before we have to hit the button and we'll get out of here, so...
It's been fantastic. Isolde, thank you very much. Tommy Boy, thank you very much.
Can I just say, Aaron, they got you hook, line and sinker.
I like that.
Mate. That
was Randy and Jason. Otherwise, it's a shame we're going to lose Leslie. I like Leslie.
It's
Aaron,
great.
Well done for being a good sport and for starting the ball rolling. Come on, Randy, don't stop clapping, people. This is how we're ending the show.
I loved it.
Co-host. For Joe for turning up every week.
Don't forget, it's
fuckers.
Don't forget the Shrine forums. There's the On the Wireless chat room. There's audioclick.co.uk, playradiouk.com for the podcast tomorrow. Hershey's Half Hour with Eddie Large coming up in 10 seconds' time.
And people, please call responsibly. We don't want to have to.
Quick
scream.
On the phone, hello. Too slow. Quick on the phone, hello. Too slow.
The following commercial will be heard by 3.3 million people.